Good evening, everybody. I've just realised in the new intro I put Leon Talks Movies instead of Leon Talks Film. Oh, dear God. I can see Leon now going, you fucking idiot. But yes, we are live. We are back with another show. Thank you very much, everybody who tuned in last week. So without further ado, I'll bring in the man who has the power of the C-bomb. It is Pete.
Hello!
And then we also have, for the time being, our third co-host, Mr. Leon. Mr. Leon Talks Film. I will change that.
Okay,
I can't believe I got that wrong.
It's okay, don't worry about it.
He was going to put Leon Talks Bollocks, but nah, that can't be right.
Oh no, don't fall.
So,
the webcam's going to fall.
Hello, everybody. As you know, Peter's here, Leon's here. We have our special guest this week, the man who's now on a hat-trick, I believe, of live streams, and that is James from Moviebug. Good
Hello.
Evening. This is your third live stream of the week, is it not?
It is, yeah. And then I was doing another one tomorrow with Jason, but we've had to move it to Wednesday. So
you could go on Jason's as well.
Oh, he's on mine this week. So
all right, okay.
Had to move it to Wednesday. So.
Oh, that reminds me, I need to put on my little. There we go.
Oh, looking well professional.
I know, man. Looking like Steve Arnott, I've got some kind of crap white 90s wrapper to my left, and then I've got a tourist underneath me.
Yep.
And I've got the man with the magical beard down and to my left, which is quite good.
Thank you.
Don't worry, that will grow in.
So yes, so anyway, James, thank you once again for coming on. You are only the second person to has come back on. The first one was Kermit, and now it's yourself. So I'm very much pleased.
Are you feeling okay?
Genuinely, it's a pleasure to come back on. It's great.
Excuse me a moment, just got to phone the
We don't know.
Where the fuck are you?
Right, hang on. Let me just mute Pete for a minute there, because he's obviously doing that. So we'll quickly go through who's in here. Now, Jamie Reed has come on, and he's put favourite The Dirty Half Dozen with Hey Day Boy Ma, which I have no idea what that means. So if anybody would like to give me a hint. Nope.
Hi, Jamie.
And anybody know what that means?
No idea.
Okay, hello. That's great. But yes, but hello, Jamie.
Good first question.
Yeah, hi, Scott's there. Hiya, Scott.
Hello.
the Brettaroo news is in the room.
Hi, Jason.
Hello, Mr. Godzilla Man.
He is. Matt Harwood, evening, guys. Hope you're all well. What do you think of Nicolas Cage film Bringing Out the Dead? And that is a Scorsese film, is it not?
It is. It's a fantastic film. It might be my favourite Scorsese film, actually. I love that film.
And it is on Star.
I think so. I think
because
it
never got released on a Blu-ray, but it is obviously HD on Star.
Yeah, it's a Disney film over here. I forgot about that. Like, not Disney, Touchstone or something, isn't it? Like, one of their companies, but oh, it's such a fantastic film. I love that film. It's like one of Nicolas Cage's most, like, I don't know, like, restrained performances, almost, if that makes sense, because a lot of people associate Nick Cage with, like, the crazy freakouts, but in that
with the kind of like, let's do it,
it's just like the absolute insanity, but he's quite restrained in that, even though it's like a very serious film, you know. And I love his performance in that. I think it's fantastic,
isn't it? I mean, have you seen it, James?
No, I actually haven't seen it. I love Scorsese, so I'm actually... It's a film which I've been meaning to watch. Now it's on Stars, and I should get around to it soon, hopefully.
Yeah. If I believe it right, because I think it was a long time ago I watched it, I think because I watched it on DVD, he's a paramedic on the night shift. Okay, yep, there we go. That's what was going on with him. So he's a medic on a... He's like paramedic on a night shift, isn't he?
Can you hear me yet?
Yeah, I'll put you back on. You're all right.
Thank you.
That's okay. So, he's on a paramedic on an evening shift, and he always does night shifts, and isn't it kind of going into his kind of persona and his mental breakdown through it, is that right?
Yeah, he's essentially, like, suffering from insomnia, so he's never sleeping, and he's doing shift after shift after shift, seeing some of, like, the weirdest things, because as a paramedic, obviously, there's some weird stuff that goes on, and he just sees, like, people on, like, life and death situations, and just, like, absolutely bonkers stuff, and it's just, I feel like it's just Scorsese at his finest. Like, I think that opening, the opening 30 minutes are so kind of intense, and they just catch you, like, they catch you immediately, and you're just, like, hooked from the beginning. I really want to rewatch it. I hope Criterion release it, because I feel like they could
It does
like
seem a more Criterion than, like, an Arrow or anything like that. It is kind of up the street.
I feel like they'll do a box set at some point. The only reason I think this is because I know there's rumors that they're going to release After Hours, which is, like, one of the most entertaining Marty films, like, out there. I love After Hours so much, and I feel like it'd do well in, like, a box set or something, that Bringing Out the Dead or anything else that hasn't made it to HD yet, like Blu-ray.
Yeah! I'm phoning you!
We're so professional on this stream. So, Pete, have you seen Bringing Out the Dead?
Nope.
Have you heard of it?
Yep.
Okay, that's fine then. Okay. So there you go. So I think after this, I'm going to put Star on and probably watch Bringing Out the Dead. But then again, it depends what time we're on till.
Nicolas Cage peaked at Next.
Next is shit.
I didn't mind that.
Next is class.
I didn't mind it. I thought it was kind of fun. It's like really goofy though, but I have fun with it.
I haven't really gone near many Nicolas Cage films. He's not someone I go out my way to watch too much. I can't lie.
I think one of the last couple of his that I probably enjoy is probably 8mm or Snake Eyes, I think.
Have you seen Mandy?
No, I started to watch it and I turned it off because I thought it was shite.
No! have you seen Colour Out of Space?
No, but I have not even touched that one.
I'm Why? Trying not to swear.
You can swear if you like, just don't. Pete will do the C word shortly, so don't worry.
Yeah, fuck it, swear, go on.
But yeah, I like Nick Cage is an actor I kind of love. I think he's in a lot of like crap films, but I really respect him because he just kind of delivers something that most other actors can't even do, really. Like, he like throws everything at the wall, and even when he's in a bad film, he's still entertaining, you know, unless he's in it for like 2 seconds.
Yeah.
And I love him, even though I can understand why people don't like him. He's like one of those actors that's like, if that kind of acting style isn't like what you're into, it's a massive turn off. I can understand that.
I could probably see him doing a Tarantino film, you know.
Oh, I'd love him to. Like,
yeah, I could see that.
Yeah. Well, I was going to say he kind of worked for him, but he didn't. But he did a trailer for Grindhouse, like one of the fake trailers in the Grindhouse double bill that Tarantino did with Robert Rodriguez. He did the Rob Zombie one, like the SS Werewolves or whatever it was called, and he played a Fu Manchu, which I thought was hilarious. I love Nick Cage.
Yeah. There we go. The Nicolas Cage love show has started. Peter's here, Playtendo guy. Hi guys, how you doing? Are you enjoying your new car, James? James got a new Mini.
I'm picking it up tomorrow.
Awesome.
That's why I've not been buying any Blu-rays lately.
It's like, so
I see you, bastard. Did you buy something I won't fit in?
I've always fancied a Mini, but I got a nice little 5-door one. I thought I'd get a bit of a bigger one.
So what you got at the minute then?
At the minute, I've got a Vauxhall Corsa that's sounds like it's about to take off. It's on its last legs.
I've been there with a Corsa. Yeah. For some reason, the electrics always seem to cut out and it stalled for no reason.
Yeah, I've had that. That happened to me about a month ago. Yeah, it's I've well and truly run this car into the ground.
yeah, that's it. It's the wolf dude Leon.
I keep getting comments like this. I don't know if it's like a troll or not, but I'm okay. Hi.
Yeah, Cyril Bass has been blocked a few times on messages already tonight.
Has he? Oh, in that case then, let me just.
I think he's been over on my stream as well before.
Jason has been out for it, I think, as well. He's looking out for him.
Slayer Reviews is here, Evander.
Hey!
You go to the BlueTube community, which is good. And I'm going to get him on live next time I get Durantnam, so you can have a word with him. Jamie's here. Good evening, guys. How are we doing? Excellent intro. Yeah, well, it was Jamie, until, obviously, I'm fucked it up, let's be honest.
I hosted it out.
Yeah. But did you notice the hidden Easter egg in there?
Robert Fett will be back?
Kind of.
Well, the E.T. soundtrack.
Was the E.T. theme tune?
Yeah.
No, not the E.T.
We're going back to pedo themes way too much.
Yeah, but we're not going on about. But that was just an Easter egg in the intro because I thought, you know, it's not going to be the same without Rob. But he has stuff to do. But I thought, I showed him the intro and he said, oh, that's great. He actually laughed and I thought, oh, well, I'm going to put, you know, at the end of every James Bond film, I always put James Bond will return. Yeah. So I thought I'd put Rob Fett will return. So yeah.
Like a bad smell.
So James, any pickups next week for anyone? Also, Movie Bug, you got caught by the sound monsters in A Quiet Place by Farting Like Me.
Yeah, that was to do with my intro for my Quiet Place review.
Oh, you know what it is? I watched your review, mm-hmm. but I must have missed the intro because I'll get a plane and I must have done something and I came back and you were halfway through doing it. So
yeah, yeah, I just done one of those little skits at the beginning that I like doing every now and then.
Well, before I get into Jamie's question, when I did my Quiet Place Part 2 review, halfway mm-hmm. through it, I go, I was going to do a funny skit. So what mm-hmm. I was going to do, so I haven't told anybody this, and 21 people who are watching this will be able to know, I was going to do a little kind of like, we're creeping through the house, mm-hmm. and then you'll just have a close-up on my feet, like tiptoeing across the top of the stairs, and then it'll go black, and it'll go, if they hear you, and it'll go back to me tiptoeing down the stairs, and then it'll come up, and then I'll be like looking around quietly, and it'll go, they will hunt you, and then it'll just be the wife there going, is this another Blu-ray?
You have to use that for the third one. Like when they make the third one, please use it.
So that was the idea. Or I was going to do the kids running towards me, as if because obviously I want to try and avoid the little fuckers.
Oh, yeah.
So that was the idea. Is that your Italian one?
Yep.
Ooh, nice, 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 nice.
And how much is that one then, Pete?
Yeah.
Was it cheaper than the UK?
Yep.
Okay, but not that cheap.
By about 20 quid.
40?
Not too bad.
Don't know.
Is your missus watching this?
Yes.
Okay. That's a nice free 4K you got there.
Mm. Got Lord of the Rings turning up on the 10th as well.
Lovely. Right, so any pickups next week? Now, obviously, I know that...
Late Mungo.
Indie's out on Monday. Late Mungo's out on Monday. I can't remember any other ones.
I did have it somewhere.
You've already got it though, haven't you?
Yeah. The stylist out, Dogs Don't Wear Pants, Toy Story 1, 2, 3, 4, 4K set, WrestleMania 37, and 3 premier titles from HMV, Escape to Victory 36 Hours, and The Sea Wolf.
Okay.
I'm getting nothing next week, I don't think.
No. I did have Indie on pre order from WoW HD. Now, obviously, after Pete said it was cheaper, so I went for that, and I think it was 62 altogether. I had it pre-ordered, and then I kind of looked at my account and looked for my spend, and I went, that's not going to even the note. So I cancelled it, but I purposely wanted the US one so I could have the digital codes, so then I could have it digitally on iTunes or Google Play 4K, as well as physical. But yeah, I cancelled that. And the only thing that I'm going to be personally getting is the Godzilla versus King Kong Steelbook, which is the 30th, is it? Or
14? I think it's the 14th. I've got two things.
Yes, 14th. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, it's week tomorrow.
I've got that and the Studio Canal Basic Instinct like collector's edition 4K thing. They're the only two things I'm getting this month, I think. And Basic Instinct is like a complete blind buy, but with the Studio Canal stuff, I noticed that those limited editions always go out of print, and they're so nice. Like the Flash Gordon one and like the Escape from New York and John Carpenter ones.
Yeah.
So I didn't want to miss out on it, just in case I do watch it, end up liking it, and then I'm like, shit, I missed out on it. So I thought I'd pre-order it.
Yeah, whatever you do, though, don't watch the second one.
I've heard the second one's awful.
Well, it's got Stan Collymore at the very beginning. As in the ex-footballer Stan Collymore. He's at the very beginning.
Oh, dear. So, you know.
Yeah, it doesn't get any better than that, that's what I'm saying. So, yeah. What about yourself, James? Anything coming?
I've only got two things on pre-order this month, Godzilla vs. Kong and the next of those big classic Doctor Who sets, which I think is the 24th, I think it comes out. It's near the end of this month.
Actually, it's a question I've got about that. Why are they not releasing them in order?
I've got no idea.
I don't get that either. It's very bizarre.
It's really strange. I think now they're sort of doing them like anniversary, because like the last one was season 8 and it came out on the 50th anniversary of that season. So I think they're trying to line them up with anniversaries, but I don't. It's annoying because I'm worried they're going to change the logo or something whenever another Doctor takes over, and they probably won't finish the boxes by then, so I'm really worried about, like, the logo changing on the spine or something.
No, I get it. I mean, I personally, I don't collect any of the Doctor Who stuff and all that, but it's like going, right, we're going to release A Quiet Place Part 2. We haven't released A Quiet Place Part 1 to buy, but then, and then after doing Part 2, we're going to release Part 4, but you haven't seen Part 3. It just doesn't make any sense.
No, it's weird. I think they done Season 12 first, because I think they used that one as a test, because it's like the most popular season of Classic Who, so they done that as a test, see if people buy it, and now they're just like, well, where do we go from here? Just we've started in the middle.
I had like a weird situation like that the other day. You know the zombie films, like the Lucio Fulci zombie, like Zombie Flesh Eaters and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
I own them all, but I was looking through like the release dates of them, and that franchise is one of the weirdest franchises I think I've ever seen in my entire life, because you've got Dawn of the Dead, which is known as Zombie in Italy. Then you've got Zombie, aka Zombie Flesh Eaters, aka Zombie 2. Then you've got Zombie Flesh Eaters 2, which is also known as Zombie 3. And then you have Zombie 5, because Zombie 5 came out before Zombie 4. And Zombie 5 has nothing to do with zombies, really, and it's called, like, Killing Birds. And then, a year after Zombie 5 came out, Zombie 4 After Death came out.
Yeah.
I think it might be the worst franchise of all time in terms of, like, releasing structure. Like, why did Zombie 5 come out before Zombie 4? Like, a year before? I'm so confused by it. If anyone in the comments understands it, please explain to me.
Speaking of which, actually, go back, this is obviously the first time I support you since Deadly Hunt, is you and I have obviously both pre-ordered the Steelbook box set of Dune, haven't we?
Yes.
That's not sold out yet.
I pre-ordered that.
Didn't it sell out? Like, I'm sure it sold out.
I'm sure, like, the 40-odd quid one did.
Yeah.
Have you seen that one, James?
Didn't we order the big massive one?
But I did pre-order the 4K set of it that Arrow were doing. I'm going to get it watched before the new one, because I'm really excited for the new one, to be fair.
Dude, none of them are sold out. They're all there.
Oh, yeah, this one's back in stock now. This was out of stock the other day, though, wasn't it? Like, this
yes, it was, because me and you ordered it, and then I think it was a couple of days later it went out of stock. It was sold out. And then that's why me and you kind of went, what's a good job I got it? Because, like, True Romance, but True Romance hasn't come back in stock.
Has it not? I've got the True Romance one pre-ordered, because I'm not missing that one.
I'm not that bothered about that one, but when Dune came out, I'm just like, I'm all over that. I just love it. It's...
David Lynch.
Yes. True Romance is gone. It is, David Lynch,
Didn't he turn down Return of the Jedi to make that movie?
He had a, like, there's like a great clip on YouTube of him, like, explaining the situation, how he met George Lucas and everything. It's such a funny story. Oh, I love David Lynch. It's like, I like Lynch so much, but I'm gonna be honest, I don't really like Dune. I've watched it twice and I don't really like it, but I still am buying it just because I love David Lynch. Like, he's my favourite director, so I couldn't miss out on it. And I'm hoping seeing it in 4K might kind of change it for me, or, like, improve it just a little bit. Also, the old Blu-ray release doesn't have subtitles, which is, like, a real pet peeve of mine. Like, I like watching stuff with subtitles, even though I'm not deaf. Like, I don't think I am anyway.
No.
But I'm glad that the new release will have, like, subs and just loads
of features. There is another company doing a release in 4K of Dune. It's a German company.
Cock
Media or something, isn't it? But their edition has every single cut of the movie. But it's like
long or something, isn't
100 euros, and it's like 5 or 8 discs. Yeah,
it's crazy.
I know I kind of paid that amount for all my Hobbit and Lord of the Rings, etc.
Mm-hmm.
But you've obviously got 3 movies in each one of those sets that you pay it for. I don't really want to pay it all for one movie, even though it's lots of cuts, and I do love Dune. Although I was in the pub last night, and I did have 3 pints, but I don't think it was because of that. I told my mate, I said, I've pre-ordered Dune, this big box set. He's like, what, with The Rock? I went, no, that's Doom. This is Dune. So that was a bit lost in translation. Yeah, can you imagine Arrow doing a box set of Doom in 4K?
The thing is, I'm not even gonna like say they wouldn't, because it's a Universal release and they keep releasing Universal films in 4K. So I genuinely wouldn't be surprised if they released it sometime.
Mm.
Like, it wouldn't surprise me. Like, because there's, like, two cuts of that film, and they just could, like, pad it out with some extras and stuff. My prediction, sometime in the next 5 years, they're releasing Doom. I'm calling it now.
You can see that as in 88 films would do that. They go with Street Fighter, I'm thinking.
True, yeah, because they've got, like, some of the video game...
Double Dragon was a 101, was it?
I think so. Yeah, I think so.
I think I got that.
That's awful. Isn't that got Robert Patrick as the buddy?
Something like that.
Second Sight released the Super Mario Bros. Film. I think they're the only people in the world who've actually released that on Blu-ray.
I got given a copy of the Super Mario Brothers one, which is like a really bad copy of it. But they've kind of added this a work print of it, which never got released. I've got that and Batman Forever, a work print as well, which different scenes in which never got released, which I haven't got around to watching, but I did put it on to see how it was. And the Super Mario Brothers one is an awful picture quality, so I can't even watch it.
I think we got them from the same person.
Yeah. So Rob. Yeah, from Rob, yeah. Thanks, Rob. I didn't want to say, but oh look, I've just lost two people because of that. Great. Honestly. We know. That's pre-ordered, actually. I pre-ordered two. One for me, one for Rob, the Steelbook of Mortal Kombat, which is out at the end in July.
There's a quick turnaround now, isn't there, with, like, the new releases?
Do you not find it weird when you go to the cinema and, like, all the trailers come on and you're like, I've seen that, I own it, I've seen that, I've got that digital.
It's like, I've seen Nobody already, but I'm still going to go see it in the cinema because that film's so much fun, but it's just, like, it's weird seeing all of these films, like, the trailers for them when I've already seen them. I think the weirdest one was, you know, when the cinemas first reopened last year, I went to see, I went to see Interstellar on IMAX, you know, the Chris Nolan film, and they had trailers for the live-action Mulan coming out, and it was like, oh, this comes out in, like, February or March or something, and I went to see it in, like, June. I went to see Interstellar in June, so they were showing, like, out-of-date trailers. I was just like, this is weird. And I think Mulan might have actually been on the Disney Plus thing at that point as well, the premiere access, like, you know, the thing they're doing with, like, Cruella and everything.
Yeah,
like, I think it was already on that. It's just surreal to see big budget films and I'm like, I've seen that at home. It's like really weird.
Anybody watch Loki yet?
It's a Wednesday,
but it was today it starts, so sick.
No, it's out on Wednesday.
Yeah, Wednesday it starts.
Because it was going to be Friday, but they moved it to a Wednesday, I think.
I've seen the reviews for the first episode, though. Sounds good. Positive so far.
This is where I think, with regards to these new series coming out, now, apologies to everybody watching, I will get your questions, we'll get there, is that a lot of my opinions differ. Now, this is only between WandaVision and Falcon and Winter Soldier. Now, I know that him below me loves WandaVision, but wasn't a big fan of the Winter Soldier, where I wasn't a big fan of WandaVision, but I absolutely loved Winter Soldier. So with Loki, I'm kind of, is it going to be a hit? Is it going to be a miss? Obviously, it will be a hit because it's Marvel. Mm-hmm. But what's it going to be like? Because I don't want them trying too hard, and then you can tell, you know?
It's got the Ragnarok tongue-in-cheekness about it, isn't it? So I think it'll be right.
Yeah, I think it might fall somewhere in the middle of WandaVision and Falcon and Winter Soldier, I think. In terms of, like, there's going to be a lot of creativity, but it's going to have a lot of action at the same time.
Did you see that set photo of Hemsworth's arms?
Yeah.
This guy's been wanking off a whale. Fucking hell.
It was that, and then he had, like, Taika Waititi with his...
Yeah.
I forgot the name of that character now.
Cork.
Cork, yeah. So you could see where he was above him.
Yeah, it was a cool photo, but yeah, Chris Hemsworth, geez, that man's massive.
You see him all on his Instagram. Hey, go on, sorry, Leo.
I was just going to say, speaking of Taika, before I forget, so is anyone here a fan of the TV show The Inbetweeners?
Yeah, I know what you're going to mention. You're going to mention the American one, because he worked on it, didn't he?
He wrote the first episode of the American pilot, and it makes me so sad, because everything else he's worked on has been amazing.
Yeah, I completely agree. It's a shame. His catalog's great, and then there's that.
I just, I don't know why he was hired to do that, but no. But everything else he's done is great. Like, I love...
Was he involved in Flight of the Conchords?
I think it's the other guy, Jermaine... What's the guy's name?
Clement.
That's the one. That's the one. Yeah, I think he might be, because I know those two worked together on What We Do in the Shadows, didn't they?
Mm.
Yeah.
Like, good. Good to see you not on the wine if you're getting a new car tomorrow.
Yeah. No, I thought I better not. I was debating whether to bring a bottle of Bulmers up here, but I thought, no, maybe not.
Why not, man? I've got mine. I'm only having the one today, so.
I'm on
juice after that.
I got my water here. I'm just boring water.
And Peter probably have his Pepsi Max cherry.
Oh, cherry's the best flavor.
It is. Like, Coke cherry is the greatest thing in the world. I'm
sorry. Yeah. No, it's just
unbeatable.
I'm a massive fan, and this is probably controversial, of Coca-Cola vanilla.
Yeah, no, I like that one as well.
Yeah, it's nice. It's nice, yeah. It's so, I can't have it too often, though.
What was the other one? Did they do a cinnamon one? No.
There was a raspberry
ginger.
One.
Ginger.
No, they did a cinnamon one for Christmas special. They did a cinnamon one. I remember that. Yes.
Do you remember, like, 10, 15 years ago when LucasAid did the Coca-Cola flavor? Like, does anyone remember that? It was so weird.
That does sound great. I'm not going to lie.
It was kind of nice, and it shouldn't have been. And then they stopped doing it, and I miss it. It was kind of nice.
The only pop that I miss is Tab Clear. I loved Tab Clear.
I don't remember that.
Tab Clear, which is basically Coke, but it was clear.
Oh, interesting.
So instead of, like, you know, on the cans, you go like that. Well, what they used to do with this one, you used to push this one down, which would relieve the pressure. Then you would push it in yourself, but it would have, like, rubber around the ring. It was, I don't know, they just did that with a Tab Clear. It was like a proper Pepsi one, but it was like, it was Coke, Coca-Cola. And yeah, it was just clear Coke, and that's all it was. It was just a gimmick.
Yeah.
But yeah, I loved that. But then they just discontinued that for some reason. I don't know why.
Yeah.
So there you go. Anyway, well, what are the questions? What is your favourite Hitchcock film?
Rope. I love Rope.
That's a good film.
Yeah, so good. Oh, Rear Window's great. Psycho's great. Vertigo. Vertigo's amazing.
That would probably be The Birds for me.
I mean, I'm just working my way through his films, funny enough, so I haven't seen them all, but I'd go Rear Window out of the ones I've seen, I think.
Yeah.
It's a really good movie. And then,
not by Northwest as well.
Well, the day after I watched Rear Window, I watched that new Netflix one, The Woman in the Window.
Yeah,
just coincidence. And it felt like such a rip-off of Rear Window.
Yeah, wasn't that like another one like 10 years ago with Shia LaBeouf, like Disturbia or something?
Disturbia,
like,
yeah.
Like a similar premise. But I've never seen it, but I've heard a lot of comparisons to Rear Window for that one as well.
Yeah, I've got that. It is tacky.
Yeah. Leon's audio seems really quiet.
Oh, sorry. I'll turn it up 1 minute.
It's all right. That was only from like 20 minutes ago, so don't worry.
Okay. I've turned it up quite a bit. Hopefully I'm not too loud.
Though. Jason's put, as we know, he picked a bluebell for 10p. It's looking like to be a Marmite. I know, a little tss, from what I've heard, mixed response Facebook. What are your thoughts? Well, I've never seen it, and I know Leon adores it. I don't think Pete's seen it.
One of my favourite films ever
made. James?
No idea.
I know the reputation. It's supposed to be good, but it's not something I'd rush out to watch.
Well, speaking of watch, sorry to interrupt. Jason's actually here.
Oh,
God.
Hello. You took so long to get to my comment, I thought I'd jump on.
So, to answer your question, has nobody seen it except Leon, and Leon's raving about it.
I love it. So, it's like one of the greatest films.
Yeah, basically, I posted the picture of the DVD that I got on Facebook, and like, I've got people going, it's really good, you love it, and I've got like my guitarist in my band going, it's the worst thing he's ever seen ever. I'm like, okay. All right, and then some people are going, it's bad, don't watch it. So someone else was like, it's probably why it's 10p, mate, or something like that. So I'm like, so it sounds like a Marmite movie.
These texts are coming through now.
Have you seen any other David Lynch stuff, Jason?
Like, I don't think so.
You've got Elephant Man, I know that, but...
Yeah, I've not watched it yet.
Okay, I think Blue Velvet is, like, weirdly enough, like, the best starting point for Lynch, because it's weird, but it's not, like, a Eraserhead or Inland Empire weird, where they're just, like, completely experimental and just, like, kind of, like... If you went in on the deep end on something like Eraserhead or Inland Empire, you'd probably either love or hate Lynch, but with Blue Velvet, you've kind of got that, like, normal... ish factor to it, but then there's also weird stuff throughout. Like, I won't give anything away, but Dennis Hopper is like incredible in that film. Like, it's one of the greatest performances I've ever seen any film.
I read the blurb on the back of the DVD, and it did sound quite familiar to Nicolas Cage's 8mm in terms of it's like an investigation that goes into a dark place. Like,
yeah,
so it sounds quite similar.
Yeah. It does, I can agree, it does have like kind of similar qualities to it, for sure, but it's just, it's weird. It's like, whenever I'm trying to recommend Lynch to someone, I just have to preface that he makes weird films, and it might be too much for some people, but I love him for that. I just love how bizarre and like unique his films are, for lack of a better term.
Do you know Twin Peaks Fire Walk With Me?
Yeah.
I've had that sat on my shelves for years, and I got it for like 50p. They're giving like 18 odd quid for it on CX.
Sell it on eBay. You could probably get like 40 quid for it.
I've already sold it in CX now.
No. Oh, it's so good. Oh, Twin Peaks Fire Walk With Me is amazing.
Yeah, I never watched it.
Have you seen Twin Peaks? Like the show?
Well, my sister liked it, so I kind of made a point of not watching it. like you do. Last time I watched something that my sister recommended, it was that what was that TV series with the gays in the nightclubs and stuff? What was it? Guy was in Game of Thrones. He was in it.
There's quite a few men who were in Game of Thrones.
Queer as Folk.
Oh right, okay.
Yeah, she introduced me to that, and the first scene she showed me was a bloke shagging a bloke and him flicking his cum on his face with his hand. And I'm like, what the fuck?
So you've got the box set and the t-shirt, yeah?
Do you?
Oh, the fan club.
Oh, you?
Yeah. No, no warning. I'm like, what the fuck, you know, but, you know. So I don't really take my sister's recommendations that well anymore.
Fair enough. Okay, quickly moving on from a come on a face. Booksy Presents is here, and he's from Cornwall. Good evening. Hello. Slay's put two of his favourite Nicolas Cage movies have to be Ghost Rider and Willy's Wonderland. I wouldn't say they're my favourite, but Willy's Wonderland is good. Ghost Rider, for me, is all right. It's enjoyable, but that's about it. Yeah, unfortunately.
I think the second's awesome. I love the second. It's like so much better than the first. It's from the Crank directors, and I just love their weird style. Like, have you seen
Crank's so good. Yeah, I love. Why has the first one never been released on Blu-ray, but the second one's everywhere?
I've got the German Blu-ray. There's a German Blu-ray you can get with an extended cut. I think I got it on Amazon for about like £6 or something.
Yeah, I got it still, but...
Yeah.
I think that's probably Jason Statham's best film.
Oh, he's amazing in it. I think Crank 2 is better than the first, but I love both of those. Like, doing a double bill of those is like one of the most rewarding cinematic experiences ever, which sounds bizarre, yeah. But I just think they're so fun.
I think Transport is good.
I need to rewatch it. I've not seen it for years.
Speaking of which, actually, I'll just take this message off. Go on, James, before I do.
I was going to say, I like the first two Transport films. I remember the third one being a bit rocky.
Yeah. When he does that fight on the bike with the bike pedals and that oil, that was amazing.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. That was really well shot, actually.
Yeah.
Has anyone watched Wrath of Man yet?
No. I'm waiting for the cinema release. I'm going to go see it in the cinema, I think.
I watched it on... I was off work last week, and because it was a bank holiday and I've been off work for a week, I lose like Christmas all track of what day it is. So I think it must have been, was it Monday or Tuesday? I can't remember what it was, but I watched it. And it's not, doesn't, when you watch it, it doesn't seem like a Guy Ritchie film.
Yeah, which I've is heard quite... it feels like a Heat, but it feels like Heat by Michael Mann, I've heard a lot of people say.
So the most annoying thing about that is there's no 4K release, but the only place that's listening in 4K is Finland.
Is it a different distributor?
Not even America.
Jamie's just sent me a link for both of the Crank movies. Thanks, Jamie. good to know you're watching. But yeah, Wrath of Man is, it just doesn't seem like a, you know, with Guy Ritchie, he's very quick paced, there's fast editing. There is certain parts of that in it, but it's just not, I don't know. It just doesn't seem like, because I've started watching, because I haven't seen in so long, I started watching Sherlock today because the kids didn't come home till about 2:30. So, and the wife was doing something. And I was like, oh, I've got the TV to myself downstairs. She's not here, she's out. I'll put the soundbar on. I've got the telly, got 4K. I'll put Sherlock on. And I was trying to faff on with all the kind of controls for the best 4K picture.
I thought you were going to have a wank then.
Yeah, well, no. I've done all that, man. I've done my 24 squirts. We're all clear with that. Yeah, but I forgot how good Sherlock actually is. It's such a good film.
I've never seen the Sherlock films, and I feel embarrassed because I've heard they're amazing. I've got them on Blu-ray, the same. I think I've got them somewhere.
They're quite good, the Sherlock films. I'm a bit sceptical on the third one, because it's not Guy Ritchie, is it? Someone else is doing it, I think.
It's Dexter Fletcher. He's the one who directed Rocketman, and he's like in a lot of the old Guy Ritchie films.
Oh,
like...
Dexter Fletcher. I remember him from Games Master.
I think it's him anyway. I might be wrong.
Get your fingers out my soup.
But didn't he finish off Bohemian Rhapsody?
He did, yeah. He shot it for like the last few weeks and then immediately went on to Rocket Man, which came out like 9 months after or something. He's got a pretty good work ethic, I'll say that. Mm. Like, he's really fast paced when it comes to that stuff.
I really loved Rocket Man, so that gives me a bit of faith in the third Sherlock film.
Yeah, you see, I didn't Rocket Man, I watched that, well, I haven't, but I started it. Mm-hmm. But I think I didn't, you know, with regard to Bohemian, now obviously it's enjoyable, but I don't think it's as good as everybody thinks it is. But I enjoyed it. So don't, if anyone's in the comments, don't kill me. I just don't think it's that good. Well, it's about a 7. Okay, there you go. Out of 10.
I agree, to be fair.
I don't really.
But with Rocket Man, it seems more of a musical. And Bohemian Rhapsody was more of like a biopic. That's why I think I started watching it and then I did all the singing and dancing. And I was just like, I'm not like a musical person. I don't want to go down that avenue.
I prefer all that.
I like Rocket Man because it's not really a biopic. Like, even like with the musical factor, it's kind of just like a look at Elton John from like an like an unfiltered perspective, but at the same time exactly in his vision entirely. It almost feels like a celebration of him and like all of the positives, all of the negatives, and I kind of like that approach. But with Bohemian Rhapsody, I would kill to see the original one with Sacha Baron Cohen before Queen start, because I don't know if you've ever heard the story of why he got fired, but they essentially wanted to make Bohemian Rhapsody all about Queen, like in like the modern day, and then he just like said no, because it's about Freddie Mercury. This is the entire point that people would go to see that film based on like his kind of life story. And I would love to see that original version, but we never got that. And I think Bohemian Rhapsody is there was an attempt, but I just feel like they kind of missed the mark a little bit. I feel like it's a bit too formulaic. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't feel like it really differentiates itself from any other biopic, but that's just me. Sorry if I offended anyone.
I agree with that, to be fair. Definitely.
Yeah.
That Wembley Stadium scene was amazing.
Yeah.
Especially when you see the behind the scenes of it, and it's just like that. And
that
just
was
the
highlight of the movie, I thought, that bit. That was awesome.
Yeah, I love that last, 20 minutes or however long it is. So good.
But yeah.
You know, I like the way the Elton John one's done from like a perspective of his therapy, and it's I thought that was really well done.
Yeah, I really like
Rocky. And I love Taron Egerton anyway, so.
He's great. I saw him, I went to, you know, when Hugh Jackman done that tour around the world, I went to see Hugh Jackman at London and he brought Taron Egerton out. he done your song because Rocket Man was just in cinemas at the time.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Because they worked on Eddie the Eagle together, didn't they?
Yeah, I think that's what they said. Because when he was bringing him out, he said, I worked with this guy on Eddie the Eagle. And I said, you know, we've got to do a musical together, we've got to sing. He said, this is the best we could do. So he brought him out, and yeah, it was awesome.
But that's thingy as well. Eddie the Eagle was Dexter Fletcher as well, wasn't it?
I think it was. I'm pretty sure it was. That's a great movie as well. I love that.
I need that on Blu-ray. I don't think it's even that expensive. I just need to pick it up.
I think it's £1, isn't it, these days?
What is it, Eagle?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I think I've seen it in there.
Need to pick it up.
I picked up a German copy and it looked like it had been gone through the wash.
I've got that film, Leon, and I can send it to you if you want.
Oh, please, please, Jason. Thank you so much.
Oh, that's how it works.
I love this community so much.
Yeah, thanks for Paranormal, by the way. And then Jamie messaged me, he was in Poundland the other day, and he was just like, have you got this one? I was like, no. So he's sending me two, so I've got one of three off you, and he's sending me two, so there's just three more to go now. But yeah, the 3D of Ghost Dimension is the most expensive.
How much is that one? Because
$740. I mean When you look, I know it's not that expensive, but when you look at the others, they're like between £2 and £3.
Hey, I'm glad that arrived.
Oh yeah, I've got mine off. Where is it? I don't even know where I put it. I've got mine off Big Paulie as well. I don't know. I had to pay for the lenticular slip though for mine. Did yours come with it?
Which one?
That one. Is that a lenticular one?
Yeah, I found that in a like cash converters for like a quid, and then I just sent it over to Jason.
I know, because you know, I was after it, and they were like, do you want it? I'm just like, oh, Paulie sent it to me. So, yeah. That's a recommendation for you, James. Add that to your list if you haven't seen it.
Yeah. No, I haven't actually. That one.
Dark Skies. Very good.
Does anybody want this?
Is that the Arrow release?
Is that, yeah, the Arrow, yeah.
Have you watched it yet?
No, I'm all right.
Yeah,
so where'd you get that from, Pete?
not from you. That's another
You sold it, didn't you?
No, I got it back already.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, for my sister, if she's watching, this is what's coming your way.
That's a double bill.
I'm going to away some films soon because I've got so much I want to get rid of off these shelves.
So I got the trilogy set, what Pete just showed, so I don't need this anymore. So if anyone in the chat wants this, just throw me a message on Instagram and I'll send it to you.
Awesome.
There you go. You've already got the set, haven't you, James?
Yeah, I've got the same one Pete just showed. I've got the preset. I think I got it like south, like £18 or something, which I thought was awesome, but have yet to watch the movies.
I think I have the Arrow set as well. Part of me wants to get the Scarlet box, but I don't think I like the films enough to like justify paying like
there's a lot of money for that.
Pounds or something, yeah, like £200. I don't want to spend that much. I don't think.
Yeah. It's scary. The original three are where it should sit. The rest of them are a load of bollocks.
Yeah, I kind of like the fifth or the sixth one, the one that's kind of like a police procedural. I thought that was kind of okay, but the rest of I binged like six or seven of those films in one day, and I think it destroyed me. Like, I don't think I ever want to watch a Hellraiser film again.
They are pretty dark. The second one as well, with the Doctor, is that's what I remember the most.
I think the first two make a really good double bill, like, because they kind of like, if I remember correctly, the second one starts where the first like ends.
Yeah, because she's in a mental asylum or something.
Yeah.
And then the Doctor finds the box and he turns into like a Cenobite, and then he's got like little things that come out of his hands, little scalpels on the end, and then he goes to the anyway. Yes, there you go. So
I was gonna say, do you think we'll ever get like a complete box set with all the films for this? Do you think?
No, I think the rights are like all over the place because they released
that with every horror film, right?
Yeah, because like the Halloween ones are quite a pain. I'm thinking of importing that Italian release, but
that's what
I'm. Films.
I'm thinking of doing that as well for the Halloween.
I just bought that like last night.
Hey, Paul, can you mute me a sec?
Yeah, hold on. Go on. Yes, yeah, that Italian one. Yeah. When you sent me that message, I was like, "You bastard!"
it's only because I had Keith on my stream on Friday, and he collects all those midnight classics, and he was talking about how great the Halloween one is. And I haven't seen all the Halloween films, so I was like, "I need it in my life because I need to basically catch up and watch just like the middle chunk that I've not seen."
Yeah,
and then I realized shipping is dirt cheap on that on Amazon Italy. It's like three.
Thank you.
How much is it all together?
Oh, it's like really.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, there. Everyone's still there. Don't worry. Sorry, say again, Jason.
£47, including shipping.
That's not bad, actually.
What for?
For the Halloween box set. Midnight Classic set.
That's a really good deal.
Considering the Shout Factory one goes for like, what, like $500 or whatever? That's like a steal.
But I think the only difference is this one doesn't have Rob Zombies in it, does it?
No. But who needs them?
Yeah, this is true.
I don't hate the Rob Zombie ones. I don't think they're great, but I don't hate them, like most people.
I also picked up in the Midnight Classics, I picked up Slither, like limited edition with a booklet and stuff, and I bought a film that my cousin keeps banging on about called The Wretched, which looks really good.
Is that the one with the skull on the front and the antlers?
Yeah.
Also, I forgot to mention, but this is the Crank release I have, by the way. So this is only cost like £6. So yeah, I'm just looking on my shelf because I know I have Slither somewhere.
Yeah,
this is what I've walked you this week, guys. I have Trainspotting 2 4K. That cost me like £1 something.
I've got the
complete Friends set. Ghoul, which is an Arrow one. Fear, which is Mark Wahlberg. You ever seen that?
Yes, it's where he's with Reese Witherspoon and he is the really dick of a boyfriend.
Yeah, that's a cool film. Goon 2. It was never released over here, was it?
I can't even remember Goon 1.
Is that Sean Williams?
Yeah. The hockey.
Oh, yeah, the hockey. Yeah, hockey. I do know what you mean. Yeah.
Series 7 of House, because I haven't watched any of those yet. War of the Roses, which is a classic. Outbreak, which I could never find over here. Naked Gun Trilogy. Yeah. The Lord of the Rings 4K set. Battlestar Galactica, the complete set. I bought it and sold it straight away, and I wanted it back, so I bought that again. Game of Thrones Series 2, 3, and 4. A film called Throwback, which looks really tacky. Rapid Fire. Somebody put that on Facebook this morning. German on there for like £6, and I already had a £5 voucher, so that cost me a couple of quid. And Dunkirk in 4K, so still got a few bits to come this week.
Just a few?
Yeah, well, I've already got Dunkirk as a steelbook, as a digibook, and as a Blu-ray, so I've got a 4K.
Of course, you do.
I picked up loads in that like Amazon sale the other week, and I think it's all finally turned up, but it's all around the shelf, so I can't be asked like collecting it all. But I think my favorite pickup, even though I know the transfer isn't that good, apparently, I love this set. Like, it arrived from
that looked really nice, actually. I looked at that a few times myself.
Yeah, it's so nice. I love how it actually has like different artwork inside as well. Like,
yeah, as opposed to the
other one. I've been wanting that for years. I'm so glad I got that now.
I like that.
That's such a nice one.
What do they call it? Diamond Lux, isn't it?
Diamond Lux, yeah.
Is that cover there? No, basically a ripoff of. I mean, that depends when it was out. You remember the teaser poster for episode 1 with Anakin, the shadow?
Yeah.
There were only 4 Diamond Luxes released in this country.
They did Batman, Green Mile, Gremlins, and like one other, didn't they?
Not the ones he's just dropping on the floor. Gone with the Wind.
Gone with the Wind.
And Batman, yeah. I was Green close. Mile. I missed Gone with the Wind.
Altogether, there were 7 in the world, but the other 3 are American and like $100 a piece.
Jesus.
So I'm never getting them.
We'll go back to the questions, since that's why we're here. Sorry to jump in. So, two Romance 4K set. I know Leon's done it. I haven't. Anybody else ordered it?
I actually have. I haven't seen it, but I watched the trailer and the set looked nice. So I was like, well, this looks like something I'd like.
It's an amazing film, though.
I chose the Die Margin trilogy over the True Romance.
I pre-ordered that as well, actually. I pre-ordered that as well. That really looks like my kind of thing. So I've been into like the old Gamera films and the Godzilla films lately. I was like, this looks like I'd enjoy that.
The Die Margin trilogy is very highly regarded in like the giant monster kaiju community. So apparently, I've not seen them, but apparently they're like some of the best kaiju films ever, so I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah, I'm really excited for those.
How is there a big monster community? That just sounds so weird to me.
It's like a fandom, isn't it? Everything's got a fandom, right?
Yeah, Diarrhea's got a fandom, isn't it? Yeah.
Even Midsommar, although Rob's not in that fandom.
when we meet up in Birmingham, what we're gonna do is get him so fucking shit faced that we're getting knocked out, and I'll get my stepbrother to come up. He's a tattoo artist, and we're gonna put Midsommar right across his back.
Okay, I'm glad that Rob might be watching this, so he knows definitely not to come now. That'll be good. But yeah, Movie Scotland. Hey guys, good evening. Hi. Mark, this Truebridge. Any of you seen 24 or Designated Survivor? I have seen all of 24. Including the reboot they did with the black guy, which I forgot that what's called that now. I watched that.
I can't remember what it's called though. I've seen some of 24. Like I watched it when I was a kid, like the first like 2 or 3 seasons, but I never finished it because it doesn't have a 4K. Not a 4K. It doesn't have a Blu-ray release, does it? No. Like I think some of the seasons are available on Blu-ray, but not all of them. Like
I think the later ones.
Yeah.
Like Redemption might be.
Smallville. You can't get the first ones on Blu-ray. You can only get the later ones. It's like, for fuck's sake.
It's so annoying. I was really worried that they weren't going to, like, finish Mr. Robot, because, like, Mr. Robot had, like, the first 3 seasons on Blu-ray, and then they did, like, a big, like, 3 pack, but when the 4th series came out, they did, like, a DVD box set of 1 to 4, and then never put the pre-order up for the, like, 4th season until, like, 2 or 3 weeks before it came out, and I was like, this is not getting a Blu-ray release, but I'm glad they finally did that, because I didn't want to have, like, a DVD for the final season, but it seems like they do that with a lot. Like,
I bought Series 1 of that. I bought Series 1, but I won't watch it until I get the other 3 series, because, I mean, Rami Malek is a fucking awesome actor. and I don't want to spoil it. I mean, I know it's supposed to be good. I know its reputation, but I have not ever watched an episode, and I want to get all four and binge watch it because I just know it looks cool.
It's not on Prime anyway.
It is on Prime.
It won't on Blu-ray.
Season 2 or Season 3 is out of print now, so you might be paying a bit for it. It's, like, ridiculously expensive. But I think, like, Season 1 and 4, and I think either 3 or 4, one of those is okay to get, but one of them is, like, out of print now for some reason, and it confuses me. So if you are picking them up, I advise picking up 2 and 3 if you can find them at a good price.
Who's that?
Oh, Pete, man. 51 minutes.
Speaking of Smallville, quickly, you mentioned Smallville, Pete, yeah? I'm sure you can get a complete series Blu-ray set. I'm sure of it. I swear I've seen it around. I could be wrong.
I don't think I have.
That's your mission tonight, Chase. Once we're finished Blu-ray. On the stream.
Let's have a look.
Did anyone see green raise up behind me then?
No. I know you farted. It's disgusting, honestly. You all got to do it, but not on my fucking stream, you know.
I mean, your fucking stream. It was our fucking stream.
My channel, then, should I say. Hope you guys have a great stream as usual. Going to pick up Skip a Victory on Blu-ray tomorrow from HMV. Yeah, it's one of the new premium titles. Mm. Leon, what accent is that, please, sir, if you don't mind me asking? Also being backtracking all your videos. Very good videos, sir.
Thank you so much, Jamie. Well, I was born in Coventry, but I live in, like, Blackpool now, so it's kind of like an amalgamation of both of those two. I don't really know how to pin my accent down.
Like, posh Welsh with itchy cheeks.
I speak to a lot of American people as well, like online and everything, so I feel like I've picked up on a few of, you know, like the euphemisms and stuff that like American people like talk. So I think I've got like an amalgamation of those three. But thank you so much for watching the videos, Jamie. I really appreciate that, and I'll be back soon, I promise. I'm on my break right now, but
you are, yeah, so which I'm very pleased that it came on here.
Oh yeah, I'm still down to do these whenever, because it's so much fun.
Cool. James is here, and then obviously Jamie said good evening, Quizmaster. What's about here? What is the oldest film by release date that you own?
It was one I picked up in that like HMV fire sale. I've not seen it yet. I'm gonna find it out, but it's like a Eureka title. I
think mine would probably be my Laurel and Hardy box set even. That would probably be my oldest, because of all of them in there.
I got this one here, this like Eureka title. It's called Madame Dewberry. I think it's number 93 in the Masters of Cinema collection. I think it came out in like 1911 or something. I've not seen it yet, though.
I think it beat me, because I think my Lauren Hardy's from the 20s.
I think that's the oldest one I have.
My
ball's
going.
Okay.
Mine's actually Lauren Hardy as well, probably.
Yeah.
I would have said I almost picked up the Arrow release of A Trip to the Moon. I almost picked that up, but I didn't, because it was like crazy expensive.
Yeah, I've been meaning to get that one actually.
Yeah, because I want the special edition, but I don't want to pay £50 for it because it's like a 15-minute film,
yeah.
And I think it's a bit too much. But if it goes on sale or something, I might pick it up sometime. I have a feeling they'll probably like. What was that Arrow release that went in the sale last time? A really crap one. The comic. I feel like they might do that with it or something, mm-hmm. and just like discount it a bit. I'll probably pick it up then. But I know they did a standard release of it too, so I might just end up getting that.
The oldest film I have, I think it is probably the oldest, is King Kong 33. Mm-hmm. I don't think I've got anything older than that in my collection.
Yeah, I watched that for the first time about 3 months ago. That it's such a good movie, that one.
It's
actually
incredible. For the time, it's unbelievable for the time.
I really love that film. I've been meaning to watch, because someone was telling me on one of my streams, you can import like the 70s one, which it might not be 70s, I could be wrong. The one that Jeff Bridges is in?
The
76 remake, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But you've got it's unless you got it's region one locked as well, though. You got to remember that.
Okay.
There is a region B Blu-ray, but it's really, like, hard to find.
Isn't it Studio Canal that released that?
Yeah, I think so.
Like,
yeah.
I think it's France or something.
But I only got it because the awesome Phil 4K sent it to me, which is awesome.
Phil is amazing, honestly. Yeah. Shout out Phil, he's great.
Yeah, shout out Phil. I don't know.
I think the oldest film I have in my collection, like, I'm just having a look because I have it all on like Letterboxd and everything, and I'm just sorting from like oldest to earliest. It's one of those films in the it's called Morocco. It's like an indicator release, this one here. Like, okay. It came out in 1930, but King Kong is like number five on that list or something, mm-hmm. like the 30s one. So like that's probably one of the oldest ones I have.
I think for me it's like James, it's Laurel Hardy, then I think it jumps to like Ten Commandments and Ben-Hur, mm-hmm. and then yeah. Lord of the Flies, the 1963 original one, I think. I think those are my latest ones.
I mean, mine's mostly, it's, you know, I don't think I've actually logged the Laurel and Hardy movies on my Letterboxd, but I've got King Kong, and then it's just like all those classic Disney films and those early Hitchcock films at the minute on there, so.
Well, actually, if that's the case, mine, well, this one would probably be Pinocchio.
Yeah. yeah.
Which was 1932?
Oh,
was that no? Was it later?
Let's have a look.
I thought it was early '40s Pinocchio.
Oh, 1940. Oh, yeah, because it might 1940. Okay, yeah, so that'll probably be the oldest one.
Are you guys like me, where the majority of your favorite films ever are older than yourselves? So is that a thing? Because I find that's the thing with me. Is a lot of my favorite films of all time is older than me.
Yeah.
My favorite film.
Because I'm older than everybody here.
My favorite film of all time came out in 1998. It's this one here. Like, yeah. I adore Buffalo 66. But, like, most of my favorite films, like, Buffalo 66, they're Blue Velvet. Like, that's, like, 1980, I think. Mm-hmm. 1980 summer.
88, I think. Is it 88?
Actually, no. Star Wars was before I was born. Yeah. The year before I was born.
Star Wars is a good choice.
Okay.
Yeah. Because then it was, like, 78 was for Halloween, the year I was born. 82 for The Thing, 80 for Empire, 84 for Ghostbusters, all
86 Aliens, yeah, stuff like that.
John Carpenter's The Thing.
I was born in 97. All my favorite films are like those blockbusters from the 70s, 80s, and 90s. So, yes.
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of my favorite films are older than me, like 54, Godzilla, 73, The Exorcist, 79, Alien. You know, mm-hmm. Planet of the Apes from 68, stuff like that.
I'm having a look to see what other films I've got in like my favourites list, if I can find it. Because I imagine most of mine are going to be like another one of my favourites, which I wouldn't say is a very good film, but John Waters, Pink Flamingos. I don't know if anyone's seen that.
Yeah, that's with the drag queen, is it?
Divine. Yeah. Oh my god. Pink Flamingos is like one of... It might be one of the worst films ever, but it's also one of the greatest films ever, I think. I love it. It is terrible, but that came out in 72. I watched that the other day again. Oh, I love that film.
Actually, no. Clockwork Orange came out before I was born as well. There's another one.
Clockwork Orange was 71 or 70... Or am I way off there?
It's 71, yeah.
Yeah, I used to hate A Clockwork Orange because I tried to watch it once and I couldn't stand it, but I rewatched it again when, you know, Mondo Celovec movies, you know, John, he did a competition video and I think he said like it was his favorite like book to film adaptation or something, and I was like, you know what,
John loves Clockwork Orange
and
loves it.
What a rewatch, it just worked for me. Like, I think it's like fantastic now, but that first viewing I couldn't get into it. I feel like I wasn't in the right mood, because you really have to be in the right mood for that. Yeah. Film, I think it's not an easy watch, but oh, it's so good.
I don't know about you guys, right? I got this thing where, because Clockwork Orange is one of those films where you've got the main character narrating the story,
yeah,
in a way. Yeah. When films do that, I tend to like get sucked in a bit more. It's the same with Cruella, right? Cruella, she kind of like narrates it, and it sucked me in and got me into it a bit quicker than a lot of films that don't do that do.
Yeah.
Well, there's one cut of Blade Runner where Harrison Ford is the narrator, isn't it?
Mm. Yeah, I think there is, yeah.
Not that cut. Oh, God.
I do agree with Jason, though, because it almost feels a bit more personal, like the character's talking to you. I can sort of... I do agree with that.
I think like, it's, Fight Club's a great example of, like, the narrator almost, like,
Boss level. Being
a character.
Boss Level, he narrates that.
I haven't seen that yet. That's the Netflix one, isn't it?
It's the one with Mel Gibson and Frank Grillo, is it?
I might be completely
wrong. The guy from Captain America, Winter Soldier, and then he comes back as, I forgot his name, and then...
Crossbones.
That's right, and I think he blows him up.
Yeah.
Doesn't Forrest Gump have a bit of narration as well? Tom Hanks narrating that a little bit?
Because he's like kind of going through his entire life.
You know the best thing about Forrest Gump? It's that it's a history lesson.
Yes.
Mm.
It's so good because the wife likes Forrest Gump. And he said, obviously, as these guys saw that, she said, I looked like Forrest Gump when I went out with the kids to the park today because I had my Bubba Gump strip hat on and I had me like my check shirt on with the button all the way up to the top. And she went, and the sunglasses on, she's like, you look like Forrest Gump. You look fucking ridiculous. Undo your top button.
I saw it on your Instagram, actually. You put that as
a caption. Yeah.
I'm so gutted, right? Because I went to Florida in 2019. I went to Universal Studios, right? And they had a Bubba Gump shrimp place at Universal Studios. But my family are all fussy eaters. No one eats shrimp apart from me. So no one wanted to come in with me. So I was like, I don't want to go on my own. I look like an idiot. So I didn't go.
To be honest, when me and the missus went and the whole Canadian family, they drove down from Canada. No. They flew down from Canada to Florida for 1 week, then we joined them for the second week, and then on our second week they went back. Anyway, we all went around Tampa Bay. Where's Tampa Bay? And there was a Bubba Gump, and I purely only went to go to the merchandise store there, and that's where I got a Bubba Gump T-shirt and I got the cap, because I fucking hate seafood. I don't touch it. I mean, the chip shop chips, that fish is fine. But I don't do prawns, I don't do shrimp, I don't do crab, I don't do any of that rubbish. Especially not salmon. God, I hate salmon. But yes, anyway, going back to the story, is I only went there to get a cap. And I got a cap.
Yeah.
And now I look like Forrest Gump, apparently. So
I have one of the worst, one of the most gutting stories when I was in Florida. That happened to me while I was in Florida. So near about like maybe 5 miles away from the hotel, there was this, probably further away than that, I had to get an Uber. But from my hotel, there was a Dragon Ball themed ramen place called Super Saiyan, and I was like, oh, I need to go. It's all Dragon Ball themed. So I'm a massive Dragon Ball fan, so I got to go. Checked on Google, it's open. I was like, awesome. I paid like $20 on an Uber just to get there, and it was closed for reservations. I was like, no. I was like, why are you doing this to me, you bastard?
You're right, Pete. So is this what you're going to say to me? Don't have kids.
You're still muted.
I haven't muted him. No, I still have. Try again. Sorry, Pete. right. What is one here? Have any of you going to media hunting at car boot sales? I've never done it because I think every time I've gone to look, whenever the car boot sales are open, is absolutely sweet effie there. I know that Tony from Horror and Todd, he goes and he gets loads when he goes, but I've never been successful when I go.
I used to do it all the time when I was much bigger into my record collecting. I used to buy loads of records, but Blu-ray wise, no, I haven't really done it.
See, I want to be on the opposite side of it. I actually want to, you know, have a table and sell stuff that I've, you know, because the house, since my dad died, we've got a bunch of stuff in the house that we can't get rid of, like in the traditional means. Mm-hmm. So me and my mum and brother have been thinking about doing our own car boot sale thing, but going somewhere, buying, you know, I think you have to pay to have a table, we pay to have a table.
Yes, yeah.
And just, yeah. I love the idea of just like haggling with people, just the idea of just being that like buy and sell haggle thing. So that's what
we did that before me and the missus got married. We had loads of stuff. I thought, oh, we'll sell it and we'll, you know, put it towards the wedding and whatever. And I went and I had loads of DVDs. But because I know my DVDs more than blue, well, because I love my films and everything, this guy was like, this and this for a quid. And I was like, no. How about 150? I was like, no, 4 quid. He says, like, oh, doesn't matter. I was like, fine, doesn't matter. See you later. I was very adamant because I'm like, I know how good this film is I'm giving to you. I know I have it on Blu-ray now, but you're not getting that for a deal. So, yes. So this is why the wife's like, right, we're not taking any more of your films to these because you're not going to sell them all. I was like, fair enough. So, yes, so there's that one. Anybody here seen the TV series Primeval? Fantastic series, same shoes, went 3 years, no Blu-ray. I believe that is with her from S Club 7?
Yes. I can't remember her name, but yeah, Primeval.
Hannah Spirit?
Yeah, I think that's right. Hannah something, yeah.
Yeah, not that I'm a fan of S Club 7. Or that I know her name and all the biographies of her, Rachel. And all those.
But Primeval was awesome. Like, the first 3 seasons. I've got behind me here, actually. I have the box set of season 1 through 3.
I love that box. That box is nice, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a cracking show. There is, because there's 5 seasons of it. I've got 4 and 5 on Blu-ray, but I didn't really like season 4 or 5. But the first 3 seasons are awesome.
I think I saw them in my local charity shop, 3 for a quid, so I might have to go and pick up them up now. I might have to go up there quickly.
Yeah, I love the concept of it. Like, these portals open up and dinosaurs come through, but they want to put them back through instead of killing them.
So it's Stargate with dinosaurs?
Pretty much, yeah.
That's it, yeah. That's awesome. Gary's here. Good evening, Gary. Gary's a legend. He sorted me out with the ritual on Blu-ray, which I'm very happy with. So I love the ritual. And if none of you have never seen it, please do. I know that probably Leon has and he loves it.
I saw it in the cinema twice because it got a theatrical release over here. Oh, it was so good.
It's weird, yeah, exactly. Peter's asking, what's your favourite David Lynch film? I would think, because I'm not a big fan of his, it would either be Dune or it would be Elephant Man, but I'd probably go Elephant Man.
I can't decide. Blue Velvet, The Straight Story, The Race Ahead, or Elephant Man. One of those four. I literally can't decide. It's like trying to pick a child. He's like my favorite Elephant character. Man. Elephant Man's so good.
It's such a good film.
Not seen any of the stuff, so I can't comment.
You've got Elephant Man, though, haven't you?
I have, but I'm awful. We know this story. We know how bad I am at getting to the films I own. It's the worst.
Yes, that's true. I mean, it did take you how many, 3 years to figure out you've got a 4K telly?
6 years, yeah.
Okay.
But the thing is, my TV's a bit weird. It only displays in 4K if I have a device that can output in 4K. So it wasn't obvious at all. Do you know what I mean?
Dude, that goes for all TVs.
And the way the guy was selling it to me was like, oh yeah, upscales. Like, as if, so I thought it was just had this weird 2K upscaler. I didn't think it was like...
Oh, so what was it, second hand then, was it?
No, this was from Curry's, like, all 6 right, okay. years ago. But not once did you say, yeah, it's 4K. So I was a bit confused. But...
Okay. Hey, James, you can carry on with your David Lynch.
Oh, yeah, no, I haven't seen any of his films either. I've nearly picked up Eraserhead, though, because it's got a Criterion, hasn't it?
Yeah, amazing release.
I've nearly picked that up a couple of times, so that'll probably be the one Well, I'm going to get Dune, but I probably will get Eraserhead at some point as well.
Can I just say now, James, you will not like Dune?
No.
No. If you do, you can slate me in your review of it when you get it and watch it, but I don't think you will like it.
No?
I don't like it.
See, I've not seen it, but I've pre-ordered the 4K as well.
Yeah.
Because
only because it's a film my dad loved, and I'm on the mission to see every film my dad loved. So.
I bought that TV series a few weeks ago.
Yes, Rob bought it for me as well.
I watched it. Yeah. Oh,
so they did the Children of Dune, which has got I forgot his name in it.
Oh, mini series.
Yeah, and it's got his name. Scottish guy. The new Professor X. Split. James McAvoy. That's the one.
James McAvoy.
Yeah, he's in it. Mm. But then I always used to play the game of Dune, where you had it was like, remember Command and Conquer?
Oh yeah.
So it was basically like that. So either House Atreides, House Harkonnen, and you had to. I can't remember the name of the third. Family, whatever, but yeah, then you just land and you had to like build your thing up, and then you had to then it was like all black. Every time your car moved, you could see all the land appearing before it, and then these enemies would come out of nowhere, and then sandworms would be there, so you'd like lose a ship or a car or whatever. But yeah, I used to love the game. It was called June 2000, I think it was. But yeah,
so what is it about the film that you don't like? I've heard it's quite a slow burn movie. Is that the main reason?
For me, I think it's kind of, it feels really rushed, because I know a lot about the production history, because Lynch had like no control over that film really, and the studio, they like trimmed it down to like a 2-hour 20-minute film when he wanted it to be like this big 4-hour like epic type thing. And the hardest thing from what I've heard about most people with Dune is it's like impossible to adapt, because the book is so abstract and weird apparently. Like, I've never read it, but I've heard it's like a really abstract novel. So Dune was David Lynch was trying to do his own thing, but then Universal were like, it needs to be like 2 hours 20, and they trimmed out so many scenes that there's an extended TV cut of it or something that's like 3.5 hours long.
And I don't know how long it is.
It's like incredibly long, like the extended cut of a film, and it has like all of the deleted scenes, but Universal refused to release the film. And I actually believe Alan Smithy, like, if anyone's aware of like the Alan Smithy thing where people like disown their films and then credit it to that director, that's what the TV cut of that film actually went to. I think it's just like the fact that it feels like so much build up and then not much happens towards the end, and it feels like it's a great world, but they don't fully like deliver on it. But I'm hoping now that I've seen it a few times, I might be able to like appreciate some of the finer details, because when I first watched Blade Runner, I hated Blade Runner, but I rewatched it like 2 weeks ago and I love it now. I think Blade Runner is great, but it's one of those films that takes a few viewings to kind of work, because it's like very hard to pinpoint what works and what doesn't work about Blade Runner in the same way as Dune. So I'm hoping like after a few viewings, I'll kind of.
I agree with you on Blade Runner. When I first watched Blade Runner, I thought, why is everybody going on about this? This is not as good. But then I watched it again, and then again, I'm like, I get it now. Especially how at the end, you're thinking, is Deckard a replicant or is he not at the end? You don't know. They kind of leave it open.
So much. As long as you watch the non-theatrical cut of that film, like the one with the voiceover and the happy ending. Oh my, I don't like that cut. That was the first version I watched, and I think that's one of the reasons I didn't like it. But the final cut, the one that came out in like 2007, that in 4K is like unreal. It's like the best 4K disc I own, I think. But yeah.
Is that the final cut?
Yeah, I've got the big box somewhere.
See that one that came out.
I've got this one here. Oh, that's fucking.
That's not Nightmare on Elm Street.
One minute. There we go. I've got this one here, which is like, it's like a digibook, but it has like all of the parts of the. Yeah.
That
like
one. Fork.
That's the one. Yeah, but I've got the full. Oh, I've got the. Oh shit! Everything's falling. I've got the 4K for it. It's got four discs. So the first disc is the Blu-ray. I don't know if you'll be able to read it.
But because I know the copy you've got is exactly the same as this, except it has the 4K of the final cut in it. Because within this one, you've got the final cut, and then you've got this too, which is the original theatrical, international theatrical, director's cut, and then you've got a bonus disc. So it's basically exactly the same as this, but it's got the 4K disc in it, I think.
I think the only other difference as well is the bonus features are on a Blu-ray disc in the 4K one. Like, I think, like, you know the one with, like, the documentary that's... Oh, what is that documentary called? One minute. Dangerous Days, yeah, like, disc 3. Like, where is disc 3? Oh. Yeah, disc 3 is on a Blu-ray. But it's, like, still, like, DVD quality. But it's nice to have it on a Blu-ray anyway.
So we're about an hour behind the questions. So because Jamie's just straight in like can't stand Dune. So that's fine, Jamie. Don't worry. We're gonna do some bullet ones here. Go straight through them because I don't want to get behind.
I've got the 3D German version of Dune.
Yeah, that's what I've got. Yeah. Pete, have you got a different hat on tonight? Yeah, well he did. You had that one of the on.
Yeah, I'm missing some grey one. Elephant bollock.
Lovely. Are there any films? So this is quick fire. So you got to. Boom, boom, boom. First thing comes to mind. And I'm going to go Leon, James, Pete, Jason. We'll go around like that. So is there any films you bought that you've sold and regretted? Leon.
I can't think off the top of my head. I only ever sell stuff if I don't like it, really. So probably not. But
James,
if someone comes to me.
That's it. You've had your time. That's it. James, next.
No, I don't really sell much, to be honest. No. I mean, most films I buy... go under my bed if I don't like them.
Fair enough. Pete?
Spaceballs Steelbook.
Straight to the point, quite literally. And Jason?
Yeah, I don't have an answer. I don't really sell what I want to keep, if that makes sense.
Yeah, I think for me, it was probably the Clone Wars, which obviously I've got back now. Because I think as soon as I sold it, the price to get it back skyrocketed.
Thank you so much for sending me season 1, by the way. Forgot to mention that.
Thank you so much.
I can't wait.
I still haven't watched it myself yet, but you know, we've got it there. We've got it to watch.
I've heard it's amazing.
God, I love it. So I love it.
You're sitting next to one of the biggest fans to your
huge poster of it on my wall. I love it.
I have a quick question. Is the Star Wars Rebels show supposed to be any good? Because they have like seasons 1-3 in CEX for like £3 a piece on Blu-ray.
Yeah.
I don't know whether to pick them up or not.
It sort of does what the Clone Wars does. The first season's very safe. And then season 2 onwards, it skyrockets. It gets amazing. Okay.
Yeah, I'll have to pick them up then. Because I'm going to go and like trade some stuff in soon at CEX. And they're like £3 each or something. It's crazy.
Yeah, it's quite good because you get to see like more of Darth Maul's story. And that character that's going to be in the Ahsoka show, Thrawn, he's in it. And he's amazing. So.
Interesting. Yes, yeah.
I know you're a big fan of Thrawn, like there, James.
I love Thrawn. I've read all of his novels, but the new one, I need to get on that.
So I haven't watched one yet, but yeah, I like the look of it.
It's good. Jason Isaacs voices the villain in that one, the Grand Inquisitor. So it's pretty cool.
I knew we'd get onto it somehow. Yes.
Yeah.
Get on. Oh, wait. I just remembered a film that I sold and I regret. I've just remembered it. It's a film
called Debbie Does Dallas. What?
No, go on. Let me finish, man, Pete.
It's a film called No One Lives. It's a really cool kind of revenge slasher film.
I've got one that I don't have anymore, but I'm kind of sad I don't have anymore, and it means a lot to me. Most people probably guessed, but it's like the old Gamera DVD, like the one that they gave away for free, like the first DVD I ever owned. I don't have that anymore because when I moved down, I love that. I love that DVD, but I've got the Arrow one now, so it's okay because it's like in 4K. It's in Blu-ray, like 4K restoration.
Yeah.
Do you know what's crazy about that Gamera DVD is that CEX sold it for £10.
10 Jesus Christ,
it's ridiculous.
When they gave it away for free, now they're selling it.
That was with like a PlayStation magazine, and now it's Jesus ridiculous. Christ. Thank you, CEX. They have my CEX has a steelbook of The Mist for like £55 or something, and I'm like, Jesus
what?
Christ,
Jesus.
Yeah, it's so expensive.
I know one is £8 in CEX,
is it?
So if anyone wants to buy it and send it to Jason.
There you go. Right, what else we got then? Lost in the Share says, I want to say thanks to Pete for introducing us to Rare Waves. Have you guys seen the Blade Runner 2049 limited edition on there with the Necco pistol model?
Oh, yeah.
I heard of that. Didn't they do one with like
shot glasses?
Yeah, shot glass. That's the one, yeah. I remember seeing that one.
Click on Blu-rays. Then just click on prices high to low, and it's like the highest price thing on there. But it's gorgeous. Yeah, it's like, I think it's about £700.
I think it was 120 when it came out, was it not originally? The guns?
It's beautiful though.
Yeah.
I'm not going to look.
Look on your faces, I guess it wasn't you guys who won the 111 million.
Oh, I forgot to tell you, this is the last live stream I'll be doing here. Next week I'll be in LA. And James Corden's actually going to be presenting instead of me, so yeah.
No, I'm not coming on next week, no.
Yeah, James Corden, the fat bastard.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with Corden. I love a bit of Corden.
I'm sorry. Yeah. I have to disagree on this one.
No. Did you hear that thing? This is a little while ago. Did you hear that Mark Kermode, the movie critic, didn't like Peter Rabbit, and then Thingy Bob's dad kind of like wrote in and wasn't happy about Mark Kermode not liking Peter Rabbit.
He was like, you shouldn't slate my son on the air or something, which is just so funny.
To be fair, Peter Rabbit was shit.
And Mark Kermode loved the second one though, apparently, which is weird. Like, I'm not gonna see it. Like, I have Limitless and I've seen every film in the cinema apart from that, and it's like the only one I'm not going to see. I don't want to see Peter Rabbit 2. Yeah.
It's not for me.
No.
Speaking of which, Gary's asking, well, he asked nearly an hour ago, so that we're trying to plod through. Seen any good movies recently? So we'll start off with Leon again.
Cruella. Cruella's like really good. I saw that three times. I've seen it once at home, twice at the cinema. It's so good. And also the new Bo Burnham like Netflix special Inside is like fantastic. He's like a comedian, but he did like a special of sorts, but it's not really a comedy special. It's like he basically filmed himself in a room for like a year, and he was basically trying to come up with sketches, skits and stuff, and it like takes like a very dark turn towards the end, but it's on Netflix. It's fantastic. I'd highly recommend that. It's like an hour and 20 minutes long or something, but they're like the best things I've seen recently.
Okay, James.
Well, I got this last week, so I've been playing through these. I watched the first one was awesome. I watched the second one before sunset this morning. That was great. Then I watched Roma the other day, which I really enjoyed. And then a couple weeks ago, and I still can't stop thinking about this movie, Battle Royale. What a great film that was.
Amazing film.
I bet you're glad you got that box set now, because I think after I spoke to you and I ordered it.
Yeah, I really didn't know whether to get it. So like, it's like 60 quid, and there's only two movies in here. I was like, I don't know whether to do it, but I'm so pleased I got it. I loved the first. The second one was a bit shit, but the first one was great.
Second one's turd. The first one's class.
Yeah,
you can get still with 12 quid at the moment, so that's not bad.
I think on Letterboxd it's like a 4.5. I've given the first one like a 4.5, and then the second one's like a 1.5.
Be generous.
What about you then, Pete?
Haven't really watched too much. I mean, I know the one film I know I bought that I can't wait to watch is Rapid Fire. I'm really happy to getting that back under the fold because I love that film. It's got Powers Booth in it as well as Brandon Lee. Yeah, brilliant film. Other than that, I haven't really watched that much in the past couple of weeks. We just really ain't got round to it.
Okay. Jason? I thought you finished. Sorry, carry on. Okay, Jason.
The obvious would be Cruella. It's my film of the year. I absolutely adored it and loved it to pieces. Aside from that, another film I would recommend is Psycho Goreman. That was fun.
Oh, I need to see that one. I've heard that's really good. That's from the ones who did The Void, isn't it? Like the throwback horror film from a few years back. Yeah. I heard
The Void is really good as well. Everyone should go and watch The Void. Yeah. That's really good as well.
It's another one I haven't watched that I got.
Yeah, I reckon. Do you like the old like Carpenter horror films, like The Thing and stuff? Because if so, you'll love The Void. So good.
With regards to the films, from my point of view, I think that any good is probably The 800, which I really enjoyed. Quiet Place Part 2, which was excellent.
Oh yeah.
Then what was the other one I was thinking of that I watched the other day, and I was like, wow, that's so good. I just thought of it just then, and I've completely. Oh yes, The Outpost, the new one on Prime.
Yeah, about I've heard the
ambush on the American camp.
Doesn't that have a 4K release, but it's like region locked or something?
The American one is a region A locked, yes, or region that's 1 so locked. But the German import, the German import was 4K. It's 20 quid on Amazon, I think, at the minute.
Interesting. I hate that we're getting region locked 4Ks because I thought it was supposed to be like a region free format.
Yeah.
And thankfully there's only like 5 releases so far that are region locked, but it's so annoying.
But the funny thing is about The Outpost is that two things is I was thinking about ordering it and then somebody put in the Facebook group, oh by the way, it's on Prime, and I was like, oh, just saved myself 20 quid. So then I watched it, but there was a show on Netflix, I think it was called Thank You for Your Service or something like that, and it was a Netflix documentary, and it was like there's so many in the series, and it was basically about dramatization and speaking to people who've been awarded the Purple Heart in America but are still alive to tell it, and the story that they do in The Outpost is one of them on there, so I kind of, and they already did like the drama, so when I was watching it I'd kind of already seen it, if that makes sense, because I'd watched the dramatization and also the interviews with the real guys who were there. But yeah, it was really good. I watched it and I thought this is probably the most realistic Gulf kind of war film that I've watched. So yeah, I gave it I haven't done a review of it. I'm not going to do a review of it, but I gave it an 8.5. It's really good.
There's one film that's made me excited that's coming out, which I don't even know you guys about it. Have you ever heard of 3 o'clock High?
No.
One where a nerd gets hit, smacked up by a bully at the end of the day, you know?
Nope.
Never seen it. Oh, man, it's a classic film. It's out in America, but it's region A locked. It's coming out of France as a digipack. It's going to be €24, and I'm like, oh, but it's such an awesome film. Just type 3 o'clock High, yeah? It is a classic. It's about his, he bumps into the guy, and that's literally it. And if you touch the guy, he wants to kill you. And through the rest of the day, everyone's like trying to wish him luck because he's going to get the shit kicked out of him at the end of the day. And it's really cool. You see this nerd grow out of himself throughout the whole day. It's a classic film.
So it's like the SpongeBob episode when he's getting bullied and he's scared to get punched. But when he does get punched, he's all like tickled.
Sounds like Toxic Avenger a little. Like the opening of the cover, Toxic Avenger.
He's been grabbed by a hand and he's coming out of a clock. And it's like, yeah. See his body. That's the one.
Oh, that's it. This looks good.
It's a classic film, it really is. And the fact that it's coming out on a region B, but €25 is a bit steep for it, you know.
Tangerine Dream did the score. I need to pick this up. Oh, I love Tangerine Dream.
You know, Kindergarten Cop, the bad guy.
Yeah.
He's the bully in it.
Oh, I need to rewatch that film. It's been years since I saw it. Like, isn't there like a new Blu-ray, like a German Blu-ray that has like a new transfer of Kindergarten Cop or something?
It's not too much. It's not at all.
I don't really need that film.
It's on Netflix, and I think that's where I always end
up. Is it on Netflix? I think that's where I'm on Netflix. I'm rewatching that later.
Yeah, I do love that.
I've told you, man. Get the app, which on your phone. I told this. I think I can't remember who it was. Just watch.
Oh yeah, I've got Just Watch. Just put it in there. Yeah, on Letterboxd, it's like one of those things where if you go to like the page on Letterboxd, if you're a pro member, it's like added to Just Watch, like the little thing there. So
all right, I've got you.
It's on, and it's on American Amazon Prime, but not UK. But I have to
the remastered version in France.
That's the one that I've heard of. I saw it on like Blu-ray.com. Like it's like a new 4K restoration or something.
Only came out last month. Yeah.
Yeah, I might need to pick that up.
€20.
There's no bathroom.
Not a tumor.
I love it so much. I love it.
It's not a tumor at all.
You know what?
No, it's not.
What I picked up in the, I don't know where it is, but in that sale, the one, you know, the Amazon sale from a few weeks ago, I picked up Jingle All the Way on Blu-ray for £1.70. Brand new.
I love that bloody film.
Yeah.
I need to find it.
Put that cookie down now.
I'm literally just going to be staring at my shelves for the next like few minutes trying to find it. It's somewhere.
We'll go to the next question then, Leon. Everybody seen a film called Control?
No.
Oh. It's about, come on, you know what it's about?
No.
Love will tear us apart. Ian Curtis?
I've never seen it.
Okay, fair enough. But lead string of, who sang Love Will Tear Us Apart again? Why is everybody gone quiet? You should all know that Love Will Tear Us Apart. Why have I forgotten who was by?
Don't know, off the top of my head.
Found it. I got it brand new for like £1.80. I'm so happy. Oh, it's such a good film.
Another pervert. I just want a Turbo Man doll.
Joy Division.
That's it. Thank you very much. Joy Division, yes. He was in Curtis' lead singer, then he hung himself halfway through when they were starting to make himself big. It was a depression single. Jamie's put nearly an hour ago. Don't forget, guys, if you need to pee, please feel the urge to take the camera with you. Yes.
I got informed about this before the stream.
I thought that might have gone viral. I got more views on the thing, but it didn't. And I don't think... I think obviously people got that far into the stream that we did last week that they probably went, yeah, we're not going to watch Dave go for a piss. Yeah, we'll just go and leave.
Well, feel lucky he does a bullet because I just had a shit, so...
Well, thanks very much. You didn't take the camera. I'm glad you didn't. There we go. Going back to the previous message, it's the 4K edition of Blade Runner 2049. The model is of the Deckard Blaster. Yes.
Yeah.
That's
nice. I have seen that, and it is beautiful.
Oh, in Florida, have a Coke Zero orange vanilla flavor, which was the best.
That sounds also interesting.
What was the first film you saw or remember seeing at the cinema?
Empire Strikes Back.
A Thomas the Tank Engine film.
Get him off this fucking live feed.
Yeah, okay. We can do that.
I think it's like the youngest memory I remember.
You calling the fat controller.
Yeah.
I can't remember what it was. I've seen a Thomas the Tank Engine film at the cinema. That's like the earliest memory I remember, but I can't remember.
I think probably Ghostbusters or Back to the Future Part 2 or Three Men and a Little Lady. It's probably my earliest memories.
For me, the earliest film, the film I can remember as far back would be The Lion King. Because I saw that in the cinema as a kid, and then the same night we went to my dad's friend who had it on pirate videotape. We watched it a second time at his house.
Nice.
I think mine was Nemo and then Revenge of the Sith a year or two later. I can't remember whether I saw Attack of the Clones or not in the cinema. Can't remember whether I saw that one in the cinema or not.
Pete?
Pardon?
What, the one you first... Oh, you said, didn't you? Empire Strikes Back, sorry. Yes,
yes I did.
Have you seen Brightburn? Yes, yeah. Loved it.
It was good. I saw it in the cinema. I can't remember too much about it, though. I remember there was like one scene in like a diner which had some pretty cool gore in. Like I remember yes. that, but
because she got glass in her eye.
Glass in her eye, yeah. That's brilliant. Yeah.
Jamie Powell just found a Spanish release of 3 o'clock high for €11.
Ooh, nice. That's pretty good.
Are you ordering it now?
Not yet.
Okay. You seen Brightburn, James?
Yeah, I didn't like it. I wasn't
a fan
of that. I
can't remember too much about it.
Like, so what was it you didn't like about it then?
I think I just wanted more from the film. They had this really cool concept of... They're basically doing what I think a lot of us wanted DC to do, to see this dark Superman. And I just don't think they really ran with it as well as they could have. I think they could have done a lot more. I like the gore factor to it and stuff, but... Yeah. All the
I
stuff showed
agree
at the
it could have been better.
I want to see that.
Yeah, I agree it could have been better, but I think I still enjoyed it. I would probably give it a 7.5, I think, would be fair for it. I loved it, but it's only a 7.5. It's not... up there. Peter's also put, I'm going through the Dirty Harry series, just watch Magna Force, great fun. Yeah, I've got the box set.
I need to see those. I've never seen
it. I tell you what, have you noticed this, which I think is great, is that if people do like their either the pickups or blue tubers like us do the full collections, there's a lot of people watch it and go, I haven't got that. Yeah, I need to get that. So like, I think I'm because the last time I put it on screen, I mean, no, Peter, I'm not saying Peter, you did this, but I got it, and then Peter's just bought them as well. So it's great. All people are like, I forgot, I didn't realize I had a Blu-ray release. I didn't realize I had a 4K release. So we basically should be getting money from Zavi, Amazon, Rarewaves, you know, everything like that.
Getting paid promotion. That's what we need.
Exactly. Yeah.
It's like the video game community on YouTube is that they'll bring a light this really obscure video game. And then all of a sudden, that obscure video game becomes super expensive because everyone wants it now.
Yeah.
And stuff like that.
Exactly. I mean, it's like I hadn't heard of the 800 until everybody started picking it up. And I was just like, all right, let's watch a trailer for that. That looks good. Bought it, loved it, kept it. It's the same with the new one from the same Cine Asia, which Jamie picked up, which is The Swordsman. I really want to see that because the trailer for that looks amazing.
Mm.
And you never heard of it, any of you?
I saw Jamie's pickups video when you got that. That's as far as I know of that film.
I think, to be honest with you, it was only because of the fact that it was from Cine Asia and it had the same logo at the top that the 800 did. And I thought, oh, I'm going to give that. I'll have a look at the trailer. I'm like, all right. But I know that the Blu-ray of 800 dropped to like £8. So I'm like, I'm waiting for this one to drop to £8 as well. And I'll get it then.
So. I can't wait till he dies. I can't wait till Clint Eastwood dies because then they'll do a whole.
I thought you were talking about Jamie for a minute there. I'm thinking.
Oh, it.
A bit harsh.
No, I'm talking about a box set. They'll bring out a box set of everything he's ever done, won't they? And that'd be
they
amazing.
They have one.
There already is one.
Yeah, like, not of everything he's ever done.
It's like £150 though, or something. Yeah. It's like the Clint Eastwood collection. 1 minute.
Yeah, but that's still not everything he's ever done.
It's got all his acting and directing.
My dad had that collection on DVD, but like we gave it to his brother because my dad's brother was a really big like Clint Eastwood fan. So unfortunately, I don't have it.
Well, it was his birthday yesterday.
Never mind. It's out of print. The Signature Film Collection retailed for £199 and now sells used for like £300. But it has 61 films in.
Who wants one then, hey?
What's that, Leon? Is that the Blu-ray, I'm guessing?
It's a Blu-ray. It came out in 2019. 1 minute.
That was a recent release.
Because there was a DVD, similar DVD release.
Yeah, that's the one, yeah. Mm. I know a couple of guys on Big Paulie's group had bought that.
Yeah, it's got 63 discs, 61 films, two documentaries, posters and art cards for all of the films. It looks insane, but it's just so expensive. And it's up to 2018. So it's like 3 years out of date, but he's only... Like, since then, he's only made, like, one or two films, hasn't he?
I'd still want it to be an Amaray case, is there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's 61 films. Imagine the size of that.
I got room.
We'll quickly go through. Favourite Jim Carrey film?
Eternal Sunshine of a Spotless Mind.
Truman Show.
Yeah, I'd go Truman Show as well.
I'm going to go Liar Liar.
Lila is good.
I don't know. I'd probably say, purely because of youth, Ace Ventura, Pet Detective, because I just thought there's so many catchphrases in that, and we still use them to this day. It's like every time I park the car, I always got the wife and go, like a glove. And she's like, what? So, yeah. Or like I come out the toilet, I'm like, do not go in there every time.
Can't wait to see what they do with the third one. That's going to be mad.
It's, yeah, well, if he does his hair, right?
I think Lai Lai has got some of his best like physical acting. He's just like, what are you doing? I'm kicking my ass. Do you mind? It's awesome.
Yeah, I think.
So, the other one where he goes, mama, and that bird's tits.
No, that's Me, Myself, and Irene. Although I do like Me, Myself, and Irene. That is
Me,
very
Myself,
good as
and
well.
Irene when he's sucking on the tits when he's in his uniform.
Yeah, and he comes up and he's got milk mustache after he sucks
on. And she's a baby. Oh, so
yeah, it's so good. Oh, when he's having the wee and it goes everywhere. Oh, brilliant. Awesome. Yes. Have you seen Liam Neeson's new film, Honestly Thief? I honestly thought it was a great film. I haven't. I want to, but I haven't.
Well, let's face it, you've probably seen the same
before. Time. Yeah. I've got The Marksman on my iTunes to watch. That's a new one, isn't it? Where he's like, let's finally get across the border and the drugs people are after them or something, I think.
I enjoyed The Commuter, though.
Yeah, that's the last one I saw, The Commuter. I saw that in the cinema. That was a pretty fun film.
It was better than I thought it would be.
Yeah. I did see Honest Thief. I didn't think it was great, though, to be honest. I thought it was all right.
Honestly? I thought Honest Thief. You honestly didn't think it was that honest?
I thought it was honestly all right.
I'll say it's full of shit.
Is it just one of those like typical kind of like the Liam Neeson action hero films that come out since Taken?
I think he's got more interesting ones myself.
Yeah, I agree. Hi guys, I've been watching Luke's here. I've been watching the BAFTAs. I forgot the BAFTAs was on.
Yeah, I watched a load of wank.
Yeah, I saw actually just before I come up to come on the stream, I saw they were doing like most iconic moment of the year, and they had all these like typical BBC shows, really low budget kind of things, and then The Mandalorian popped up with Luke at the end, and I'm like, well, surely that's gonna win. I mean, it's Star Wars and it's massive budget, and it didn't win.
Normally it's whichever fucker turns up wins it, but you know.
That John Favreau there on screen as well. I was like, oh, come on, surely he's going to win. They're going to want John Favreau to do a bit of talking, but no, give it to someone else.
Bastards. That was quality scene as well. And I actually got welled up at that point as well. Don't know why. So this is normally when the wife comes in and goes, are you being a salty bastard again? Yes, I am. Look, he's Grogu's going back. Look. Fuck off, Paul. Seriously. Yes. Now, favourite Harry Potter film? For Peter, it is Prisoner of Azkaban. I'm not a massive Harry Potter fan, so I've only seen the first one, so I don't know any of the others. So,
get off the stream and watch it now, right now.
Does not interest me. I own them all digitally, but it doesn't interest me.
I'd say watch the first three, because the third one, Prisoner of Azkaban, is like, it's not just a great Harry Potter film, it's like a great film in general. Like, it's directed by Alfonso Cuarón, who did Gravity, Children of Men, Roma, all of those films, and he is an amazing director. So I think get through the first two if you're not like huge on them, and that third film is just amazing. It's got like time travel in it and stuff. It's so cool. It's so good.
Yeah, I think the third one's the best one, definitely.
Yeah, so good. Love it.
And just remember, Gravity's coming out in 4K in October.
Not 3D though. Gravity should be in 3D all the time. That's what it was built for.
Yeah, amazing.
I've not seen any Harry Potter film.
Oh, good man. I'm giving you a virtual high five there, Jason.
You won't be able to reach it.
It's a cool little universe. I don't know why you don't want to watch it.
I think it's just the fact it came out the same time as Lord of the Rings motion pictures came out. And to me, it was like Lord of the Rings for grown-ups, Harry Potter for kids. And I've always thought that way. I mean, that's me being stupid, I know. And I know that. But I just always thought Harry Potter's for kids, Lord of the Rings for grown-ups. And then that's why I went down that route.
This is me being real. I just didn't care. That's it. I just didn't care.
To be fair, I think I sort of grew up on them because I remember like my parents would take me to see them at the cinema. And the atmosphere when the last one came out was incredible. I've never experienced anything like it. Like everyone was just...
The emotions in the cinema freaks you out, doesn't it?
Yeah, it was... Do you know what though? One thing I really hate about the last film is how dark it is. I remember watching it at the cinema and half time I was like, I can't see what's happening. Like the shot where Voldemort and his army are on the hill. And the camera pans over to them for the first time. It's just loads of little white dots on their heads. I'm like, I can't see anything.
Yeah.
There you go.
See, but, yeah. with the Harry Potter films, right? So my mum loves them. She's got all them all on DVD, and she goes, "You should watch them. They're really good." I was like, "I'm sure they're good. I just don't care." And also, I don't want to watch them on DVD. I'd rather if I'm going to go and watch them, I'd rather go and buy the Blu-ray set or the 4K set. And
Oh, it's actually right here next to me. I've got this set on like an Amazon deal for like £30.
That's 100 quid in CX.
Yeah, that's so expensive now. Jeez.
Yeah. But it's a really nice set, this, to be fair. I love the cover.
Have you seen the treasure chest? Have you seen the treasure chest?
Yeah, yeah. Isn't that like the massive one that like unfolds or something?
Yeah.
That one's a bit much, I think. I don't know where I'd put it.
Oh, I've been thinking about it. It's been going up and down like a yo-yo in price on Amazon.
Yeah. But no, I really like that Harry Potter set I've got, actually. But,
I worked in a bank when that came out, and one of the teller girls, they were clearing out some stuff, and she found a first edition of Philosopher's Stone.
Oh, really?
Yeah, sold it for £7,000. And that was back then. I mean, they're worth £30,000 now.
I actually had Philosopher's Stone and what's the second one? Chamber of Secrets on VHS. Yeah. Having them on VHS as a kid.
isn't that film called something different in America?
Yeah, like the Sorcerer's Stone.
Yeah, Sorcerer's Stone. Yeah.
Also, when I was in Florida, I remember going on the TV. I was in Florida in 2011, and they had the fifth one on, and it was on the TV. It was called Harry Potter: Dumbledore's Army. I've never seen that anywhere else, because like on the Blu-ray release, it's still Order of the Phoenix, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, Order of the Phoenix, yeah. I've never heard that before.
No, that was really odd.
Kiss of me and Jess, aren't they going? Talking about Harry Potter. Yes.
The thing is, now I've planted the seed to get the Blu-ray set in my brain, so I'm just like, should I spend money I don't have? Should I do
it? About 30 quid second hand.
Yeah.
I mean, the cheapest right now is about £28 on Music Magpie.
I think I've spent over my budget this month already, and I've even got Godzilla vs Kong coming to get paid for as well. So I don't think I can really buy anything else unless it's from like charity shops for a quid or something.
I did a little cheeky thing last night. Always, whenever I go out drinking, I always end up on eBay or Zavvi. I don't know why. It always happens. And the next morning, I'm like, thanks, Paul. Your confirmation email. I'm like, oh, what have I bought now? So I bought the, I showed you guys in the group, but yeah, I bought, you know how Rob had that Mortal Kombat black T-shirt?
Oh, yeah.
With the fire that I bought. Well, they did a white one, because the fight one, the black one is Scorpion, and the white one has got the blue emblem with Sub-Zero on it. But the Scorpion one was still like 16 quid, but the other one was like reduced to £8.99.
Mm-hmm.
I said, Mrs., I do white T-shirts. She's like, I don't know. I'm like, it's Mortal Kombat. I'm going to do a white T-shirt. So I'm getting a white T-shirt.
So, yeah. The
wife went, when we went up to the pub last night, I'm like, wait, I said, the wife, what are you wearing? She's like, I have a summer dress on. I was like, all right. She goes, what are you wearing? I went, got me Cobra Kai T-shirt. Put a shirt on top. Boom.
I done something similar. I think when the HMV sale was on, it was in that sort of in-between period where the pub's open for a bit. I was in the pub with my mates, and I'd had one too many, of course. Next morning, I look, and I'd ordered, like, 6 HMV premiums. I was like...
I don't do white shirts, but I've got this one here, which is, like, Slaughtered Lamb from American Werewolf. Oh, I love it so much.
All I do is white shirts.
I tell you what, right? I've always been black shirt kind of guy, yeah? Over the last year, I've moved away from black T-shirts and I've had more colour T-shirts and got into more kind of just wearing more colour stuff.
I think the brightest one I own is probably my blue Dunder Mifflin T-shirt. I saw Dum Drums, the channel Dum Drums. I've seen that one. There's a movie Mad's got that exactly. He wore that on his last tape video as well. I saw that. But he had a T-shirt on it. And it's got like, it says Assistant Regional Manager, but underneath Assistant, it's got to the. Just it's small, right? And I'm just like, I need that T-shirt.
I talked to Movie Mad today.
You're what?
I talked to Movie Mad today when I'm on the live stream.
You want him on here?
Yeah.
I'll get him on. I don't mind. I'll ask him. Because we've got that we're free on the 27th.
Oh, we'll sort that out.
Go on.
Do you know what I bought last night? Star Wars Episode The Force Awakens Steelbook. 90p.
Jesus Christ.
Blu-ray?
Wow.
Okay.
And Amazon as well.
That's crazy.
Paul, you should get in contact with Keith when we throw your pictures.
I've asked Keith before,
I've got a thing about that. Me and him spoke about that. He said, "Oh yeah, he's been asked. You asked him to come on before, but he wasn't confident on the camera at that point."
Right, that's right. Yeah,
he was a bit, you know, nervous.
Did you see that fucking wall behind him?
Awesome, yeah. But God. Now he's a lot more confident. He's more.
Do you think if I asked him, he'd come on?
I reckon he would. Yeah. It was on my stream, so I don't.
And he did 5 hours, didn't he?
Yeah, 5.5 hours we're on Friday.
I think you need to get John on, like Mondo Chalovec.
John doesn't can't do Sundays. He works. I've asked John. See, I've asked Keith. I've asked everybody. Don't worry. I've asked everybody. They've all said no. The only people who've actually turned around and said yes because I'm desperate are you guys. So let's be honest. That's where we are. No. But John said he worked on a Sunday, so he couldn't do it. Or he's through work. And then Keith, as Jason said, because it was a while ago. This is when we first started. He said this is before Keith went on camera. Yeah. So he didn't. So yeah, I might ask him. I'm asking if he wants to come on, see if we can do
he's a top bloke, absolute top bloke.
Well, actually, randomly, I've never probably spoken to him, like you haven't, until the stream on Friday. And I messaged him before your stream because of the Child's Play Midnight Classics was €13. Yeah. And I messaged him and he said, "Oh, thanks, Paul, but I've already got it." I'm like, okay, just because I saw it, I don't know what you're getting. So yeah.
Do you know, it's a wonder I got any money left. I just had to buy a £200 mirror that the missus wanted. And she came back off her bingo little trip with a Diamondique dog. Like a pug, like, not a pug, what's the other one? French Bulldog, silver, covered in diamonds, all right? And I'm under orders to find it a dog bed.
Is this like a jewel?
It's actually a dog about this big. It's silver, covered in like diamantes. And I'm under orders to find him a bed so we can put it next to the electric fire, and because we're blinging up the lounge and it's looking good. The fuck am I? I'm not going to spend £20 on a fucking bed for a plastic dog. And I'm just, but then I know there's films due coming in the door in the week, so I need to like balance it really.
If anybody's watching this stream and you've got a bed for a diamante dog, contact Pete below on 0800 need a bed for a dog and he'll pick it up straight away from you.
About this, that is the most niche request I think I've ever heard, or niche request, like, ever.
No, I think the worst one I've ever heard is, well, somebody shaved my beanbag. That's about the worst one I've ever heard.
Right. I'm going to go backwards and forwards. Last on shares, the most recent one is, if Dynasty Warriors gets a physical Blu-ray 4K release, I bet you ask, I'm going to get it. The visual effects of the trailer are great, if not better than those in Mortal Kombat.
Does what it mean.
I've never. Which one's Dynasty Warriors?
Based on the game, wasn't it?
I recognised it. Oh, yeah, I tell you what.
Like 10 of them.
I know the game. Yeah.
I tell you what I remembered. This is how random it is. I was watching one of Rob's friends' streams, and he got some toys. So then I put the toys, the name of the series for the toys, into YouTube for the intro because I remember watching it as a kid. And then this took me to another guy's channel, and this guy's got like 14 million subscribers. And it's for Dino Riders. Do you remember Dino Riders?
Yeah.
No.
You're basically old enough. So basically, it's about there's the goodies, which are humans, and the baddies. I forgot the names. Yeah, and then like the baddies are like all like animals, but they're like humanoid animals. So there's one with a snake head, one with a beetle head, one with a frog head, and they have a fight. And then the humans are getting whipped their ass, so they hit a button and go into time warp, and then the other fun come behind us, and they're back on prehistoric Earth. So then they're able to communicate with the dinosaurs to ride them, and then put weapons on them. But the other ones control them with a brain mask, and it's about that. That's basically it. Yeah, it's basically dinosaurs, but with like weapons and everything on them.
Sounds pretty fun.
Yeah.
In case you guys think I'm full of shit, this is my wish list on Amazon right now. I mean, look at this fucking one. Look.
That's our bed.
$7.99.
I wouldn't spend that much on a real dog, but for a real dog, let alone a model.
Yeah. No shit.
Alan's here.
Hello.
Good evening,
hello.
Alan.
Hey.
Yes.
Hello, Alan.
In case you're watching, Alan, this is not. I'm not going to court. This is the new thing I'm going to be doing for my live streams. I will have a shirt and waistcoat. I'll let Steve on it, line of duty, you know. So if he gets all the ladies, I'm sure I won't.
I think we'll pick up the premieres tomorrow.
You probably will. Both the show films are great. One, isn't there a third coming? Yeah, I think we went over that one. Where are we?
I've got to get them 4K. I've got them still booking normal, but I've got to get the 4K.
Nice covers, actually. The two that they've just released on 4K. I bet when the third one eventually comes out, they don't match it, though.
Oh, no. I tell you what, right?
You're in
this
the two
is what really irked my mate last night. Because, you know, I put the pictures of these on Instagram, right? So when I put a picture of these on Instagram, I put them on like that, right? And he's like, that's really pissed me off. I'm like, why? He's like, because you put the sequel before the first one. I'm like, yeah, but if you put it that way, it doesn't work as good because the blotch isn't, like... So it looks better like that because the white... So, yeah. That was his Urk last night when I put him on Instagram.
You know, you need a new mate.
He looks like you. Good looking lad, you know.
Well, you know, it's a curse.
Right.
There's ugly fat bastards in the world, yeah. It's hard to be fat and this big and still look good.
But somehow you managed to pull it off, Pete.
And remember, guys, I still have the hammer.
This is true. Yes. Yes, I remember that. We've also got Durant going for a piss last week and you threatening Rob with a hammer. So that was a good stream. Yeah.
Mm.
Yes, not for that. I'm glad I put not for kids in the fucking thing.
Yeah.
Right, favourite Kubrick film? The Shining, of course.
Amazing.
I'd go 2001, I think.
2001 is so good as well.
Yeah. This means he's got so many.
I'd have to say 2001. It's just so clean to me.
Mm.
You know, this seems like such a patience for filming it, you know? Like, it took dedication to do that one, if you ask me.
And it still stands up, like, what, 50, 60 years later. Like, it hasn't aged whatsoever, which is, like, insane, especially for a film that's, like, sci-fi related, because with sci-fi it's always like predicting the future almost, and sometimes they can come across a bit dated, like looking back on them, but there's something about that film that just, it's timeless, you know. It doesn't feel like it came out when it came out. It feels like it could have come out 10 years ago and it'd still be the same film, which I love it.
Going from clean to unclean, I'd probably choose Clockwork Orange, to be honest.
Really good film.
I think for me it's a toss-up between Shining and Full Metal Jacket.
I picked up the 4K for Full Metal Jacket because it's in that 2 for $25.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed Barry Lyndon as well.
Barry Lyndon's good.
I've got that, but I've never watched it.
I've got a box set of Kubrick's things, like wherever it is, and I've only seen Clockwork and Shining in that. No, Full Metal. I haven't seen Barry Lyndon. I haven't seen 2001. I haven't seen Eyes Wide Shut.
I need to see Eyes Wide Shut.
I haven't even finished seeing Spartacus. I've started it, but I haven't finished it.
What's the first one? I haven't seen Lolita either. I've heard that one's quite good, but the subject matter is one that I don't really want to like go for right now. It seems like a bit of a dark film.
While we're on about the box that I've got down here, did you want me to show you that Tarantino one again at all, Leon? Just rub it in.
Please don't.
I don't mind. It's just an arm's reach. I could just slowly just put it across the screen like that.
Oh, I can't make it to next week's stream. I'm sorry. I'm kidding.
Yeah. She'll be burgling him.
Yeah. He's got my address as well, which is worrying. Look at the door. I'll be like, the wife will be, who's it? It's Leon. Paul's mate off YouTube. Oh, not another one. Yeah. Upstairs, help yourself. Well, what? Yeah. You'd see him running down the street with this box set.
Bloody Tarantino.
That's what it says, but my nan found the big sleeve edition of Blu-ray Trainspotting 2 yesterday in scope for £2, so picked that up for him.
Nice.
That's pretty good. That's amazing.
The Diamond Box Gremlins box set he's had for years, I would have sent it to you, Peter, if I'd known.
Oh. My mate's had it for years, and he always refused to sell it to me. And I said, well, I'll wait till you die then, and I'll just take it. But I finally got it.
What's your favourite Godzilla film out of the Criterion box set?
The original.
Yeah, the original.
Yeah, I'd agree.
I'm biased though. It's my favorite film of all time.
It's such a great film.
Yeah. I haven't got it. I haven't seen it. And like you said, with regards to Harry Potter, it doesn't really. That's the original fair. Stuff doesn't do it.
That's fair. It's not for everyone though. Like that specifically, that first movie. It's very bleak. It's very depressing. Mm. It's definitely not. It's not.
To be honest, I'd watch them, but I don't think I'd pay so much for a big box set of them. You know what I mean? Yeah. So at least I can say I've watched them.
The hand combat fights. I just want to have a stroke.
Have you? Are you? Do you have a multi-region player?
No.
Sorry, Paul. Do you have a multi-region player?
No, but if you want to send me one, Leon, please do.
I was going to say, because Criterion have released the first one standalone, you can pick that up as well, but it's like region 8 locked. That's the only issue.
I need to get. I keep looking. I don't want to pay like 120 to 150 for a multi region Blu ray player, because the one I use downstairs is primarily my 4K one. Yeah. And then the one I use up here is just my PlayStation 3, which I use for my Blu rays and my 3Ds, and that's it. So. Although I'd like it because it kind of opens the market up a bit, because you can just order a Blu-ray and you'd be like, doesn't matter because I'm be able to watch it.
I will say, since I got mine, which was probably about like 14, 15 months ago, it has completely changed how I collect. And I feel so much like freer now, like I can just buy anything. I don't have to worry when like, I wanted that, you know, the Friday the 13th Shout Factory set, and I was like,
yeah,
but it's going to be region locked. And then I think I picked up my player like a month or two after that came out, and I was like, I'm getting that now. And I'm really glad that I'm able to get some of the ones from like Shout Factory and Criterion.
Have they, just when you bought it, had they sorted the discs out before, or have you still got to send off for the new ones?
Well, I think I got it when it came out. Like, I pre-ordered it from a... it was weird. It was really weird. I pre-ordered it on eBay from, like, a UK seller called, like, Toys and Games or something. And even... they sent it out, like, 2 weeks before it came out. So my unboxing on YouTube is, like... it's, like, 2 weeks before Street Day. I don't know how they got it in the UK 2 weeks early. But it had, like, the defective discs. I just... I emailed Shout Factory, like, through the replacement program, and they just sent them over, which I was quite surprised by, considering, you know, it's, like, an import and everything. But they just sent them over, and it took, like... 3 weeks, maybe 3-4 weeks. So it was pretty good. I've got the replacement discs still. I think I need to get rid of them. Like, give them.
I traded in my the Viking without doing the discs. I couldn't be asked.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, Eric the Viking.
That was Signal One. Is that Signal One, or is it like a boutique label or something? Yeah, because they replaced that recently. Didn't it look like a DVD or something? Like the transfer.
Yeah, it looked really bad.
Yeah.
My mindset on getting a multi-region player, because I don't have one either.
Yeah.
Is the idea that, like, I'm reckless with my the little money I get. I'm reckless with it. I know if I get a multi-region player.
Give us a fucking board.
Oh god. what do you want, Rob?
Hi.
You're on the stream, Rob.
Is that it?
What's going on?
I thought you were on a break.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, carry on, Jason.
Yeah, I'm reckless with the little money that I do have. So if I got a multi-region player where I can get anything from anywhere, like the Friday the 13th box set, for example, I think I'd be even more reckless and might be spending more money. So I'm holding off as much as I can, because I know it's just going to get me into financial trouble if I do.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Yeah. I hate. It's almost like, I think since I started, I used to buy, before I started YouTube channel, I used to buy a lot more Blu-rays. I think I have evened off a lot since then. But all of a sudden, it's almost like you feel like you need to get some Blu-rays to show off. And I don't want to go down that avenue.
Yeah.
Like that Justice League steelbook that I got, it was. I hated doing it, but as soon as it arrived in the door and I came straight up here knowing exactly what it was, I opened it, did a video straight away of the unboxing out there within seconds of it coming through the post. And I've had like 600 to 700 views of it. It's just, you know.
Yeah, I like the issue I have is like I try to do the same thing sometimes, like with the Lake Mungo second sight, like they dispatched that like a week ago. I've had it in my house for a week, and I know if I did the video, it probably would have got like a ton of views. But I'm just like right now, especially with like, you know, the break and everything that I'm having, I'm just like, I can't make that video. But like, I know people would like that video because obviously people are like interested, you know, to see what's inside the set and everything, and I'd love to do it, but I don't feel like I'm ready to like do videos yet still. It's weird, but I know it would benefit the channel if I did it, if that makes any sense. It's like when you've got like an early release or like a release on day one, if you get that video out, it can do like really well, you know, but I just don't feel in the mindset to do it right now.
My Gamera video, my Gamera Arrow box set video, like, is on like almost 2,000 views because I was the first person to get that on YouTube.
That's awesome.
To get it up, so that's done really well. But I've not once have I said, well, I better do this for every new release because they're all going to do well. Like, no, I'm not going to do that for every release. That'd be boring. So
oh yeah, exactly. You're right. The only reason I did it for Justice League Steelbook because it was Justice League Steelbook. That was it.
Yeah.
I'm, you know, if Indiana Jones 4K arrived this weekend, you would do it because Indiana Jones 4K.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, if like, I don't know, if I just grab an like, oh, not that one. Anyone? Yeah. So like, if that arrived, Alan Partridge off the pat, but I'm not going to do an unboxing of that because you wouldn't really get that many views for it. You've got to cater for the audience, really.
It's funny because I did an unboxing of my Godzilla King of the Monsters steelbook that I got, 4K steelbook. But just because I wanted to do it, I didn't care if it did well or not. I just wanted to unbox it on the channel because it looked awesome.
I tell you what really pissed me off, although it's kind of not, is when I told you guys at the time, it's changed now, but when I did Durant's stream last week, by the Tuesday, it was 80% of people who had watched it had not subscribed to my channel. I'm almost like, I'm giving you this for free, and you're not even giving me anything back.
It's understandable.
It's usually, but the thing is, you'll find that's a norm, though, because I think half of the viewership on my channel are not subscribed to me.
Yeah.
I don't know what mine's like.
It is the norm, but you'll find that.
So, anyway, we'll go through stuff, because what time do you want to stay till, James, by the way? Because I know you're at work tomorrow, are you?
Yeah, I'll stay till 11. Yeah, okay. I'm up at 4:30 tomorrow, so.
I'll tell you what, we'll do 2:45, because I've got to get rid of this out of the way, and then bring my works computer forward, get it all set up. So we'll do till 2:45. Is that all right with everybody?
Yeah,
absolutely. If anyone wants to hang in backstage afterwards and chat, I'm open to staying up and having a chat if anyone wants to sit up and chat, whatever.
I remember last time you two were on, and I was like, I'll just check. Yeah, they're still there. Oh, jeez. Yeah. Did you do what you wanted for like an hour and a half or something afterwards?
Something like that, yeah. It was fun.
It was. Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, it was fun.
Right, what's this? Guys, when do you think HMV will do another 2 for 15 on premium, or have they realized they'll probably lose loads? I don't think they'll do it again.
I saw someone in the it was either one of the groups or on Blu-ray.com that said they spoke to one of the managers at their HMV and they said they're never going to do it again. But some people think it's just a tactic to get people to buy now instead of like holding off for another sale. I hope they do another because that's where I get like all of my premium collection releases. I don't think I've ever bought one like full price.
They're doing 20% off Criterion at the moment, aren't they?
I know, but it's still expensive even with 20% off. So like
I think I bought half my premium collection during the 2 for £15 deal. I think in the space of like 6 weeks, I bought like 40 of them.
Yeah, is that when you were drunk as well?
I was definitely drunk for a few of them, yeah.
I have a video on from like the sale last year, and I think I picked up like about, what, like 40 titles as well last year, like during that big sale, and I still haven't watched half of them. I need to get around to watching them still.
It's actually my favourite collection to go to because I like half of them I haven't seen. I like going there and just picking out one that I haven't seen, actually.
Yeah, they're really, like, for $7.50, they're so good. Like, for the slipcase, the, like, sometimes they have, like, a few of them have reversible artwork, but not many. Mm-hmm. Like, I know, Gattaca, I think, and what's the Brian De Palma one? Casualties of War? I don't know if you've got that one, but that has reversible artwork as well. That's a really good film.
There's still some titles that I want to get from that. We're like Valley of Guanji, I want to get that. There's a few I want to get still, but I'm waiting for that 2 for £15 deal because I don't want to pay 2 for £25.
This is my new American guy, The Video Place. Have all of you adapted to 4K, and if so, what's your thoughts on the format?
I collect 4K quite often, but For most films, especially like the new visual effects heavy ones, I just stick with Blu-ray now, I think. I feel like HDR's good, but a lot of them are just kind of upscale, so I just tend to get like the older films on 4K usually. Like if there's like a Stanley Kubrick film, like something like 2001, The Shining, they look amazing, but for newer films, I usually tend to just get a Blu-ray now.
Yeah, I mainly changed to 4K for the PlayStation 5. It's mostly for my games. I don't even play games much, so I don't really know why, but I have got a few 4Ks recently, and it's funny, some look amazing, and some, you know, you're just there for more, like, the sound quality and stuff.
Yeah, but you got to look at it. I've always said it, you got to look at the equipment you use as well. People buy a £500 Toshiba 65-inch, it ain't going to look as good as a £1,500 LG 65-inch.
No, exactly, yeah.
You know, my whole equipment downstairs is about £4,500 worth, but then... Mm-hmm. I don't drink, I don't smoke, never have. This is where it really comes into play. This is what we like to do.
Yeah.
You know, I still want to get my laser TV.
Yeah,
keep getting itching about that when I think about it.
I'm obviously fairly new to the whole 4K thing, but no, I think it's completely changed my outlook on visual, like, visual
fidelity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and stuff like that. So, I'm excited to. Thing is, I'm more excited to check out older films on 4K. Oh, yeah. You know, stuff like that. So, I'm always on the lookout for more kind of older stuff. I don't even know if The Exorcist has a 4K release.
No,
I picked up The Exorcist on Blu-ray yesterday for like. I never had it in the collection, and I guarantee they'll announce like a 4K tomorrow. Like they'll do it. They'll announce a 4K tomorrow. Now I've picked it up.
Yeah, you know the Final Fantasy Advent Children?
Yeah.
I picked it up on the Sunday on Blu-ray, and on the Monday they fucking announced the 4K. It's like, motherfucker.
The one I had to wait for, and I was like, I'm convinced they're never going to do it, was The Lost Boys, and now there's like rumors that they're releasing it next year for like an anniversary. I'm like, for fuck's sake. I waited like years to pick it up. And
I'm surprised it hasn't come out, to be fair.
Yeah, it needs a 4K. Like, I've not seen the Blu-ray yet, but I love that film.
I have a question.
Go on, Jess.
Yeah.
Do you guys? Because I don't really notice a difference from DVD to Blu-ray. Animated stuff. Is there a big jump from Blu-ray to 4K with animated?
I'm trying to think of the film because
I watched Moana in 4K, and wow, that looked incredible. I've got to say.
I'm trying to think of what I have in 4K.
I don't think I have any 4K animated. The only one I want is Raya.
I have The Lion King somewhere.
The Lion King looks... It was. I thought the colours popped a bit more in Lion King.
Mm.
I don't know.
It didn't wow me, though. It was good.
No, I agree,
I'll say one that looks great in 4K. Into the Spider-Verse. That looks amazing in 4K.
Actually, no. That is the... Actually, there you go. That's the only 4K animated that I own.
That's a really good shout, actually.
That's so good.
Yeah.
Quick other question. Is the Jurassic Park 4K set worth buying?
If you like Jurassic Park, yes. If you got the Blu-ray, there's not that much of an upgrade.
See, I'm waiting for Dominion to come out. I'm hoping they do a 6-film box set, and I'll buy that.
Yeah,
I would.
See, I've got the 2011 Ultimate Trilogy Blu-ray set, which is meant to be the better transfer compared to the 2013. Re-released, so I don't know what.
I mean, I'll be honest. I've obviously got them all here in like. I've got them all steelbook. There goes my. It was not only is it out of time, it's out of the bloody window. So the point. This is the hardest one to get in 4K for a good price, on the steelbook.
I've seen the other steelbooks for about £15 a go, brand new.
Yeah. But yeah, I to be honest with you, I've only put them in just to check the work because I got them off eBay. But I wouldn't say there's a dramatic jump from, like, for example, if you're watching The Shining now, you go, whoa, done such a good transfer on that.
Yeah.
With this, I think the picture's minimal, but I think the sound will be phenomenal, but my speakers aren't that good. I've only got a soundbar, I haven't got Atmos, I haven't got anything like that. But yeah, so I only got these because I'm a big fan of the Jurassic Dinosaur, like, series. So that's why I got them. And that's why the only reason I upgrade from Blu-ray to 4K is if picture quality is good, I really like the film, or it's like a film that I really like and I've had on Blu-ray, then I'll upgrade. Like Sherlock is not that good in 4K. It's a little bit better. You can see a little bit more detail. But I love the two films, so I have to get them. Not that I have to get them, you know. It's the same as
well coded on the Blu-ray, wasn't it? So,
yeah.
See, my my TV upscales. When I've got my, I got an Xbox One plugged into my TV. My TV's got upscaling software, so when I put the Blu-ray into my Xbox through my TV, the upscaling's pretty awesome. So I'm wondering whether my just standard Blu-ray Jurassic Park set would look great upscaled anyway.
I think perhaps the only difference you'd get is like HDR. Like that can be like a pretty big difference sometimes for some films, like completely change it. But I was going to actually ask a question. What's everyone's favorite like 4K release they own? Like for me, it's Blade Runner. I think it looks amazing. But like,
are we talking about for the film, or are we talking about the picture?
The picture quality, like transfer in terms of like, you know, this is like the best 4K.
I haven't watched Blade Runner 2049 in 4K yet, but everyone says that's the best. So I reckon I can fully get on board with that. But the, out of the ones I've watched, Dawn and War of the Planet of the Apes. Wow. It looks amazing.
Yeah.
Not the best film, but picture quality. This is out of this world.
Yeah, 60 frames a second, isn't it?
Gemini Man. Yeah, 60 frames per second one. Whenever anybody says to me, what's the best 4K you own? I'll go, I'm a bit like the guys in Spare Change. I'm like, I'm here to review the picture, not the movie. I'm like, it's Gemini Man. That is the best picture quality I have. The opening scene when he's on the grass and he's, they haven't. Plus, it's in 60 frames.
Doesn't it have that soap opera vibe?
Yes. 60 frames per second. Yes.
Because that could throw me off a little bit.
See, I don't mind that. I really don't mind that because he did that on Leland's halftime walk as well. And that doesn't bother me whatsoever.
Remember, your TV's probably 50 hertz anyway.
But that's another one. Billy Lynn's Halftime Walk. It's another really good 4K. And Life of Pi. Life of Pi looks amazing in 4K.
I've not seen that film yet.
I need to see it. I've got it somewhere.
So, have you seen Oblivion in 4K?
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
No.
I don't think I've seen Oblivion.
I've got about 18 titles on 4K currently, and I think I've only watched like three of them. Which is
About 170, I think.
But Godzilla 2014, Pacific Rim, and Thor. And Godzilla 2014 was probably the best looking.
Maybe Dunkirk as well. The dogfight scene.
Stuff looks amazing.
The dogfight scene. When the fight, and it's like, because it goes full IMAX screen, it goes full screen. The clarity on the water is just unbelievable.
I was going to say, most Warner Brothers 4Ks look amazing. I think, like, I got all the DC and all the MonsterVerse films, like Godzilla, Skull Island, King of the Monsters, they all look great.
Amazing 4K release as well. Like, Interstellar's another one I didn't, like, love when I first saw it, but that 4K is just, like, it kind of changed it for me. Like, that and seeing it in IMAX. Oh, my God. Such a beautiful film.
I'm still going to hammer home that I watched Kong Skull Island on Blu-ray upscaled, and it looked unbelievable.
That's a really good 3D.
But I've just got the 4K, so I'm expecting my mind to blow with the 4K.
It looks awesome, actually. I rewatched them in preparation for Godzilla vs. Kong, all in 4K. Yeah. They look amazing, those three films.
I can't wait for Godzilla vs. Kong 4K. I can't wait to get that.
I'm, like, really excited for it, mainly because it's, like, mastered in 4K, which, like you know, the digital effects and everything. And, like, some of the older ones were, like, 2K, so I'm expecting the Godzilla vs. Kong one to look just absolutely insane in, like, true 4K. Like, I think it looks so good.
The last half hour is going to be amazing.
I need to get a Dolby Atmos. What basically happens is we need to fast forward. The kids can fuck off and find their own place. Their downstairs playroom is going to get changed into a cinema room. I'm going to get
I'll come and build that for you.
Okay, you can come up. I'm going to try and get to, obviously this has to get clearance, which is not going to happen. I want to get a projector, and like a 4K projector, Dolby Atmos with two seats, maybe just like normal settee or whatever facing it. So it's basically where it is here, but underneath in the kids' playroom. But yeah, it's not going to happen. But you're going to have a dream, haven't you?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Some people dream of winning the lottery and living abroad, and I just want.
My mum's friends' family, they're multimillionaires and they have their own cinema in their house, and it's ridiculous. It makes me feel like why I'm even existing anymore. Because yeah. I will never ever achieve this in my life.
I'll be happy. Just I don't want a cinema room. I just want. I mean, obviously, I've got posters all around here, but obviously, still got a bed in here. I've got my work desk here. I just want to. So I go in there, kind of somehow soundproof the walls because it'll be downstairs. But we don't have any neighbours to this side, and the neighbours which are attached are deaf, I suppose, so we're fine there. And just get like the thing to come down, speakers there, Dolby Atmos, put it all on. But then, if you guys, right? This is the last question, and then we'll finish the stream. I've just thought of this. You've got your own cinema room. You've built it. You've got Atmos. You've got a massive TV. It's your own thing. You can play any 4K for the sound and for the picture. Which film would you choose to put on first?
Matrix.
I feel like a broken record, but again, Blade Runner. I feel like that film would just look amazing. Or Interstellar, like any of those two. Or like 2000... I can't decide. There's so many that are coming to my head right now. Like, I think 2001 would actually look pretty great.
Every time I get a new TV, the first film I always put on is Revenge of the Sith. Because I love that movie. So it would just, it'd have to be that.
So with that question, Paul, I can pick any film, even if it doesn't exist on 4K, in theory.
In theory, yeah. You know, but it's something that you would think would use and utilize the surround sound, the 4K, you know, it's the first time you've built it. It's took you a year to build. You're going to sit down, you're going to experience it in surround sound in your own place.
Okay, I'll probably pick something like Saving Private Ryan, something like just fucking intense, just massive. Mm.
How about Black Hawk Down? Yeah. All the helicopters, that'd be... Mm.
See, I think after watching The Outpost last night, I'd probably go for something like that, so probably 13 hours, Secret Soldiers of Benghazi. I think that would look awesome and sound awesome.
Yeah.
You've seen that one, did you guys, yeah?
I haven't seen it, no.
I've not seen it. I haven't got it, is it? It's still downstairs because I'm actually going to watch it at the minute.
I was going to say, I actually got to do some work in like a private cinema the other day. I don't know how well it was going to come out, but like I took like a video in there of it because it was so amazing. Like all these seats, all these nice lights.
That's awesome.
So where was that? Was this a mid?
Nah, this is it's just a company I do work for. We were putting like some signage just on the door and stuff, but we got to go in there and have a look and it was so nice. Like, they done
actually in there. That's what I was gonna ask. You know how you work for a printing company and you sometimes do posters?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's all right, yeah.
Yeah. How big a posters can you do? So if I said to you, can you possibly be nice and send me a poster, which I can't find anywhere, would you be able to do it?
It depends, because like I make posters for my mates as well, and they send me them. But if they're like really small quality online, as soon as I blow them up, they get all pixelated. So because I just nick them off the internet. So if they're good quality, I can print them for a decent size because I've got loads around my room. Like I made a little Godzilla corner the other day, made like two Godzillas and a King Kong one. I made my mate one who's obsessed with killer clowns, and I found this really nice like Mondo one, which was really good size. So I blew that up for him. So it all just depends on what the size is on Google.
Because I'm not saying I need, but I'm wanting a Gladiator one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But
you cannot find a maxi-sized... Like those size ones anywhere online of Gladiator for some reason or other, and I don't know why.
Well, the only problem is like mine, I print on like Diabond, so it's like really solid. So I'm not sure how I'd get a big one, big poster to you.
True.
I'll be back.
What, Pete? We're going. Pete, we're going.
Okay.
Right. We'll get rid of the What we'll do then, fuck that, just Pete's doing. So what I'll say is, obviously, thanks again, James, for coming on. I much appreciate it. You've obviously met Leon as well for the first time.
Yes.
Nice to meet you. Nice
obviously,
to meet
Jason, you've already met before.
Oh, no, it's my first time on a stream with Jason as well.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Yeah. But well, we're doing one on Wednesday.
Wednesday, yeah. Look forward to it, man. I look forward to it.
Yeah, no, it'll be good.
Yeah. Sorry.
Are you back? Okay, right. Yeah. So, yeah, so I'm just wrapping up, Pete, because I'm going to finish it there. Like I was just saying, thanks to James for coming on. Thanks to Leon for being amazing and stepping in on his time off. Thanks to Jason of accepting the invite, because I'm interested to all the guys that could come on the stream tonight. And Jason's the only one who decided to come on. So fuck the rest of you. Go on, Joe.
I don't think that's a good thing. I don't know whether I'm a good thing or not.
No. I'm more than happy for anybody to come on. Yeah, that's it. So thanks for... Oh, actually, hang on. Pete.
Yeah.
You haven't said the C word.
Can't.
Wow, brilliant.
There we go. Well, so yes, thanks everybody for watching again. James for coming on. Sorry if I didn't get through all your questions. The thing is that when we start chatting, we just go on and on and on, and all of us, you know, Lane will notice that, James knows that, Jason knows that. You get to a question, but like, oh yeah, that was from like 3 hours ago, so it's not the word. But yes, that's it. Anybody got any videos coming up this week you want to tell people about?
I do. I have my tomorrow morning at 8:30 a.m. is dropping my complete Arrow video collection, because I'm doing my complete collection series. So I did my anime last week and got my Arrow one tomorrow. I think episode 3 is going to be my Disney collection. I'm just going to move on like that. So look forward to those videos, guys. Appreciate it.
Pete will be doing his Monday releases tomorrow.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
I have no plans for any videos at all, unless something arrives, I think. Leon's on a break. James, anything coming?
Nothing at the minute. I don't know. So probably just some of those spur-of-the-moment videos might come up, but that's about it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and I'm not doing anything. Next week, we have Preston, that fat samurai guy. That's our second American guy coming on. So if you're not all subscribed to that fat samurai guy, fat with a PH, please subscribe to him. And then the following week, we've got Movies and Sue. Both those guys are in the BlueTube community group. So I'm building Americans coming in there, which is great.
Awesome.
And then after that, we're free. So I have I've got a few, what's the word? A few things in the fire? Is that a few? I've forgotten the phrase. I'm working on a few people to come on. The best thing is I book them, and Pete and Rob, or Pete and Leon, won't know who it is until I go, this guy's on next week, and they're like, oh, okay. So that's it. So thanks again for watching. I'm gonna go because I'm back at work tomorrow after a week off. James is up at probably 5:30.
Yeah, 4:30 tomorrow.
4:30. Yep. And then Leon and Jason probably stay in the chat afterwards.
Oh, I speak till 3 a.m. So
yes, we're gonna go. So thank you very much for everybody for watching, and I'll see you next week, and see all of us and our videos during the week.